Going live. Wow. You can really go live. Is it going? Or is it going? Excellent connection. Thank you. How's the sound, Lauren? How's the sound? Yell Baba Booey if you can hear me. Do it. Oh, you texted. Alright. I need to focus it. You love this part. Why has it been so weird? There we go. Wait. Good enough. Oh, Dave. I don't like when it's all zoomed in. How do we look? We too bright? We look good.
Looks good. Oh, we're both wearing black and white?
Well, yeah. So I set it up like last time so you can see the comments easier and the camera's not blocking anything.
I love it.
I wanted to see if there's a way to move it, but I realized you probably want the screens flipped and us to switch seats moving forward so it's mirrored.
I don't
care. And if something's really like trying to point, we're like, huh. Hey, Margaret!
Oh, Margaret! Yeah, I don't think it matters.
How do I mute this?
Hey, Andrew. Let me just
mute it.
The volume down. It's called volume on the side of your phone. You have the same one? Have you ever used a phone before?
I was trying to mute it on this stream right there, just like a mute. David, come here. You look extra beautiful, David. Come here. You got to show everyone how cute you look today.
Come on.
Come on.
Come on.
David with the pearls got new pearls! Pearls for the girls!
Andrew wants to know if we know anything about refinancing.
We do. We know that you would need to talk to a mortgage lender.
Hi, Maddie.
As much as I would love to help you, we are not licensed or able to do that.
But we have a wonderful mortgage guy, Philip Kuhn with CNF Mortgage, who's...
His website's Philip, or we can put it in there. It's philipcoon.com.
Yeah, he's really...
And you can fill out an application on their website. Let him know that you know us. Can't hurt, because we send him a lot of business, and he takes good care of our clients.
He's really cool. He's our age.
What, 34-ish?
I think he's younger than me, actually, so wait, maybe 31.
I think he's... No. No.
I think he's younger than me.
I think he's 2 years younger than me, so he's like 33. I think he's your age. David, they can't see your pearls.
22 people?
Whoa!
But only, so 22 people watching, but only 6 people in there.
I don't know, maybe that's lagging.
Not right. That's not right.
Here, let me take it off Wi-Fi because it seemed weird. We'll go to cell phone.
Yeah.
And then maybe we'll hit refresh.
Our Wi-Fi's been really weird the past couple weeks, y'all. So.
We upgraded to the newest Ryzen routers, and it was better, but it's still... Something's weird.
Also, Tall Boy White Claw. Alex was so excited about these.
Oxford Cellars. Another reason I love Richmond. They're so cool. I was like, can you order literally as much Grapefruit White Claw as you can get? And they're like, I got you. And now we have a year's supply. What Grapefruit White Claw?
A normal person's 1 year supply.
Should we tell them how much we got?
No.
Okay. That was a lot.
Yeah. What's everybody else drinking?
Yo, 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 Maddie Wilson.
So, our,
It's dessert week.
It is dessert week. So, Margaret that said hi on here...
Is player of the week.
Well, I don't know if that... that's what I'm kind of asking. Because we've had more than one Margaret play before.
Margaret, who said, hey, guys. Are you Margaret L? Player of the week. Did we get a little bio or no?
Yeah.
Okay. I wasn't sure. I didn't keep up with the text.
Maybe. Okay, it's her. Perfect. Perfect. What are you drinking, Margaret? What are you drinking, Alex?
Oh. Since it was dessert week, I found this pig pancake ale with maple syrup barrels. So it was aged in maple syrup barrels.
Got it. She's drinking water. And as
proud
I
of
say
you.
That, I don't know if she's of legal drinking age at this moment, but she'll get
you. You didn't specify. Yeah, you said, what are you drinking?
You're right.
Water.
No, you're exactly right.
So me and Lauren are trying to drink the appropriate amount of water now because I was getting like leg cramps and everyone's like, you're probably dehydrated. So we got a hydration app and we're hydration buddies, so we can keep track on each other. And I've noticed a difference. I feel better. I'm getting less cramps. Water for the win. We're not allowed to drink beer until we've had our
daily water
intake. Daily water intake first.
More Starburst.
Lauren does love Starburst.
Miles
Starburst. Really loves Starburst.
Yeah.
All right, let's take a look at this beautiful beer.
Pancake ale.
Ooh, I thought it'd be darker for some reason.
Yeah, I would assume.
But pancakes are, you know, kind of this color. A little light but golden.
Oh, you're using your etched mug.
Oh, yeah.
I saw something on, I don't know where I saw it, but they were making pancakes and they, like, put the batter on the...
On a waffle iron?
On the griddle. No, but then they just drizzled syrup into the wet batter before they flipped it.
Oh, I think I saw it. I also saw where someone cooked pancakes in the air fryer and they used wax paper and they did like six at a time and it looked like it worked. I don't know how the texture would have been, but so this is Center of the Universe shirts versus blouses.
Is that Prince?
I imagine that's in Prince. Yeah,
from Prince dunking a stack of
pancakes. Because there was like a Dave Chappelle skit where Charlie Murphy or somebody played him in basketball and Prince like destroyed him, shirt versus blouses, and I think at the end he fed him pancakes.
Versus
so this
blouses.
Is oat-based blonde ale made in maple syrup barrels.
Maddie says that he was wearing his Glazer Group t-shirt today, had some dog friends say, hey, I love the Glazer Group, and it turns out they're Insta fans, and hopefully they're doing
what,
trivia.
The dog part?
That's awesome. That's really cool. Yeah, what does it taste like? It doesn't, it smells
so
like
I'm
beer,
so,
Margaret, to
I'm
be honest.
I'm so used to IPAs, it's very mellow and mild.
It just
tastes like a beer with like 5%, not even, just a hint of syrup. Mm. It's not even that sweet.
I feel like I'm drinking like Donald Trump drinks water.
What? Awkwardly and...
This is so full.
Dave, you have an itchy ear.
I mean, it just kind of tastes like beer.
Yeah, we're such IPA people. If it's not an IPA, I'm like,
That's a good question. Are pancakes dessert or breakfast? Well, when I was...
Without syrup, it's less desserty.
I was noticing, though, when I was coming up with my trivia questions, that a lot of breakfast foods are also desserts.
Is that all you can say without giving away hints?
No hint. It just is. Like, a donut could be dessert or it could be breakfast. Or, I mean, anything's breakfast if you eat it first thing in the morning.
But
right?
Also, when you do breakfast for dinner, you're eating specific breakfast foods like bacon, eggs, pancakes, waffles, French toast.
Can you
get dessert for breakfast? Where you're just like eating cake? You're like,
dessert
good morning.
You don't need that because you can actually eat breakfast foods. Ew.
What? I was going to take a bite without a fork.
Yeah, don't do that.
Why?
Why would you have to eat cake for breakfast when you could...
Shindigs.
Fresh fruit cake's the best thing ever. Why would you get cake for breakfast when you could get actual breakfast food and not look like a fat ass with, like, a cinnamon roll or a waffle with whipped cream?
Come on. You want it, you gotta get on camera. If you want cake, got a camera. There you go. I know you're hungry.
Here you go.
David, Namika's blocking. No one can see how cute David is when she destroys the fork. Everyone loves shindigs.
Yeah, the fresh fruit cake is
Lauren?
The best. What flavor cake is it? Alicia.
It's fresh fruit cake.
Oh, it's a fresh fruit cake. It's like white cake.
All right, Miko. Oh, if you're about to kick the iPad over.
And it's got like,
Normally you'd think fruitcake, you're like, eh. This is 10 out of 10. Like, it's hard to explain.
Okay,
it's so...
stop talking for like 1 second and let me explain this cake. Thank you.
I'll eat. How about that?
Thank you. It's got like berries and kiwi and like other fresh fruits chopped up that they put in between the layers with the frosting. And it's really good. Really good.
I feel like I just got diabetes and I liked it.
There's a hair in it.
That was probably Miko's.
Everything in our life, just dog hair. Hmm. Okay, now...
The best bites are the bite with the hunk of fruit.
Now Andrew wants to hear what you have to say about the cake.
So, it's almost too sweet for me, but then you get a big hunk of fruit, and the fruit's actually less sweet, and it just, like, I guess it balances very well.
Yeah, Margaret says the fresh fruit makes it feel lighter, which is nice.
It makes it feel healthy.
Agreed. Now, this is breakfast. I'm good right now. I do agree with that.
I'm not picking my mouth. It just itches. Yeah, you do it with your nose all the time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like this. Mm-hmm. My brain just itches. If anybody here says that they don't pick their nose, they're a liar.
Yeah, but you like pick your nose on cam and you're like, I'm not picking my nose, it just itches. But no boogers come out, so I think you're not lying.
True. Okay, it's 7:24.
We have a new 8-minute countdown because Lauren always feels rushed, and I love her and I want her to be happy.
Oh, maybe.
So this has nothing to do with Richmond or trivia, but how freaking cute is this? Where did you see this?
I don't know. Maybe like probably some dog group that I'm on Facebook. Yeah, it's a Costco set of dog toys. There's a...
From BarkBox, so you know they're extra cute.
A little Costco card that's got a chunk out of it. There's a hot dog, a soda. Luna's jealous.
So I don't know when, but I bought 5 of these. 1 for us and 4 to give away. But I don't know, it's got to be like a dog-related night or... Because what if you don't have dogs? What are you going to do with this?
Yeah, you're not.
Pizza! Maybe we'll give them away on Instagram so people can say, yes, I have a dog and I want that.
I think that's a good one.
Follow us on Instagram if you want a chance to win super cute Costco toys. Maybe's obsessed with all new toys.
Wait, look at this one. It's a soda. How cute is that?
Here, get it.
Look, and it's one. It's Bark brand.
Bark
so
Box.
The brand that does Bark Box. So they're really... good quality. Why is, toys?
Why is this crooked? Did the dog like
it took a bite out of it? Yeah.
The card?
And look, the Costco card says good dog member.
Now this is the one that kind of weirds me out, the hot dog and the way the eyeballs are. I don't know about this one. It almost looks like a weird like crab man.
Christy said one of her dogs is trying to find the squeaker they just heard.
Alright. Follow us on Instagram. We're going to give away 4 sets of these. We are also almost finished with our Trailside Treehouse video. And we're going to be giving away a 1-night stay at the Trailside Treehouse. So you have to follow us on Instagram to be able to win that. So when we put up the Instagram information, start following us. Keep an eye on our story.
Trivia is happening in 5 minutes. Join us.
What else is almost done? We've got some other stuff in the works. So every time we put out a Why Richmond is Awesome video, we always do a giveaway, and that's always through Instagram.
Let's see. I was making sure I didn't miss anything on Insta.
Miko wants cake. Oh, it's the first time you'll ever hung out with us during trivia, Miko. Alright, maybe one more bite. Only because you're my favorite. Well, I bet you gotta get on camera though.
Here you go.
I say Mika's my favorite because maybe she is, but she's very shy and emo. And I feel like when we got David, I was worried that she'd just get like forgotten about and like sad. So I make a really big deal about everything she does.
Alicia, you got your hair done at, with Lauren? Good.
Miko 2020.
Alright, so it is dessert week, so Miss Margaret we have here is the player of the week, and so she chose the prizes, she chooses the best team name, and yeah.
How are we looking?
We have 46 people in the game, and we have 44.
So it kind of adds up.
Here.
So tonight's room code is Glazer Group because we're actually the sponsors for the first round.
That's me.
We do sponsorships for anyone who gives away the bonus prize.
Mm-hmm.
We need to do a little bit better planning, so I'm pretty sure Shindigs would have, but we just...
Okay, it's not a lack of planning, it's the fact that we, like, just implemented this, and so we haven't had a chance to, like...
We need to figure out players of the week ahead of time.
Alex,
to
we've talked out. About this. I know. But I understand what we need to do.
We need to pick, like, 4 players of the week now for the next 4 weeks so we can plan it all and get it ready before that night.
We're working on it. Anyway, so for this first game, the first and second place prizes are to Shindigs because they're amazing and Margaret loves them as well. And then the bonus prize is just Alicia, they volunteers.
We'll put you on the list.
The bonus prize is just $25 cold hard cash.
Because that's how we roll.
Or dough. You like that? Also,
but we highly would love if you spin it locally at a restaurant or brewery or business.
Yes. Somebody messaged on Insta earlier and she was like, hey, I'm not in a position to be able to stream the game, but can you tell me the first room code? Because I still want to play. I'm like, oh, that's cute. Like, she's like, I'm a dedicated player.
Yeah.
Oh, Nikki, I know it is. I know.
Thinking or coming up with all of the questions every week is hard for Lauren, too.
I was going to say, but honestly, if coming up with a name is the hardest part of trivia, then for you, then...
Well, no, thinking up a winning name is hard.
Right. All right.
You don't have to come up with a name. You can just say Nikki Johnson.
Yeah, but who's...
What's the fun in that? All
right, I'm going to start this little old countdown. All right,
so
right
here's
here.
The new...
Wait, can I do
yep,
it?
Yep, so when you press go, you'll see the countdown on the bottom. Boom.
Cool. All right.
So you can take your time and talk real slow.
Well, today's not, I mean, it might not take us 8 minutes because we are is also the sponsor. Anyway.
Should we explain why Richmond is awesome more? A little more?
I don't know.
For anyone who doesn't know. So we're the Glazer Group. We're local real estate agents. We love Richmond, so we started Why Richmond is Awesome just to promote and support all the cool stuff around town. We have an Instagram, which I'll put up in a second. We have a YouTube channel and a website, whyrichmondisawesome.com, where we just like to share, you know, what's going on and cool stuff, and we make lots of fun videos sharing our experiences with that stuff, not only on Instagram stories, but our YouTube videos are very highly produced and polished, and I love helping make those. Shout out to Michael Snell and Miles AG Productions for helping us. They're on our team, and we love them to death.
Yep.
And then Sam. Yeah, we definitely couldn't do it without her, too. She's a big help with our Instagram part of the whole Why Richmond is Awesome. And just planning and coordinating and all that fun stuff. But check it out. You know, if you haven't already, you know, go to our YouTube channel. I know there's a lot of trivia recordings. Scroll past those, and you'll get to all the ones we did pre-pandemic. And we're slowly doing some production on some stuff as safely as we can.
They're also on our Instagram. I was going
IGTV.
Through our yeah. Instagram, and they kind of all have the same...
video?
Like, cover of this. If you're going through our feed...
Well, it says the name, and then the background is different, but it's faded, so it's like not like super obvious, but yeah. Because there's a podcast that's, I think, yellow, and then the We're Why Richmond is Awesome videos, and you have the blue tag.
Like, like you can see the those ones were the play
zoom,
button.
The zoom cast,
I know, but
yeah.
Then these. Yeah, you can see.
There's not going to be a penalty shot because we're not going to mess up, Andrew.
All right, so we are local real estate agents. We already talked about that. Why Richmond is Awesome. Today's prizes. So for this round, for first place... A $50 gift card to Shindigs.
Oh, Dave,
this is our fresh
bite?
Fruitcake.
Dave, just the corner.
Stop.
You don't think she'll do it?
No. And then second place is a
also Shindigs.
$5 gift card to Shindigs. And then a random winner between third place and last place gets $25 cash
cold hard
money
Venmo.
Courtesy of the Glazer Group.
That's you.
That's me.
That's you.
Somebody's asking about your shirt.
Oh, Rest in Pieces. We love that store. It's down in Oregon Hill. I guess you'd call it an oddity shop. Mm-hmm. They've got a variety of taxidermy, skeletons, skulls, old creepy stuff like a 300-year-old or 100-year-old Ouija board. It's hard to explain. You just gotta go and just walk around. There's like a bunch of like animal teeth. I don't know.
It's cool.
It's cool.
I mean, but I'm into that kind of stuff.
Lauren's into it, and she's gotten me into it, and she bought me this shirt, and it's really soft.
It's right by Hollywood Cemetery, too, so if you're looking for like something to do, walk around. Also fun. Matt, we had the DiGiorno croissant pizza last week, and it was really good.
It's pretty good. It's not, you know, pizza bones, but
it was good.
It's still good.
Okay, quick little words about...
You want to go to Trivia Club or you want to go to next?
I was going to go How to Play.
Okay, sure. Whatever.
So if anybody is here for the first time, I see we have 74 players. If in the next 4 minutes we get up to 100, we'll give away $100.
Oh.
But for anybody's new here, it is best to have two devices. One, like a computer, TV, laptop to watch us here on YouTube Live. And then it's best to have a second device to actually play the game, like your cell phone. The camera's backwards. It's really weird. But to actually play the game, you are going to go to crowd.live. The room code is Glazer Group with an S, Glazer, G-L-A-S-E-R.
It's like laser.
With a G.
Like sharks with freaking glazer beams on mm-hmm. their heads.
Or if you just go to crowd.live/Glazer Group, then it will take you right there. Best team name gets $20.
Margaret is picking that. Player of the week.
Player of the week, Margaret, gets to choose that. Oh, thank you. This is
nice. It is fancy.
Geode pop socket. So, yes, our player of the week, Margaret, gets to pick the best team name. She also chose the theme, which is dessert week, and she also chose the prizes, which is shindigs, and next is proper pie. But Miss Margaret says that she's been playing for a couple months. She is a sophomore at University of Mary Washington. I almost went there. They have the most beautiful campus I've ever seen. She is planning on majoring in psychology and in the College of Education. Her goal is to be a teacher. She loves to travel, and trivia has been the highlight of her week since she started playing.
That's so cute. I love all you guys.
I know, it's cute. But also, so I realized today, Margaret, that a lot of these dessert questions are kind of like, where are they from? And I thought it was kind of fitting because you like to travel, and she mentioned that she was like, with like questions on other countries. And
Sarah,
stuff.
I got it. We got the upside down and it's phenomenal. Should we like this video? I don't know what that means.
Should we like it on...
Pizza Bone, and this is totally off topic. Pizza Bone and Zorch did a one-time only collaboration and it's already done.
One time only, like...
For now.
Right. The first ever, maybe you should say.
It was good.
All right, we got 2 minutes left.
Subscribe to YouTube and follow us on Instagram because, as I mentioned earlier, we're giving away these cool dog toys and we're going to be giving away a night stay at the Trailside Treehouse here very mm-hmm. soon. And if you're not part of Trivia Club, I don't understand why you're not.
So you can text us your phone number. Obviously, if you text us, we'll have your phone number. If you want emails, you can do that. We send out an email and or text every day before trivia.
Just one. We don't spam you. Just one email a week, one text a week.
That's it. And we give you at least a free hint to each game. And we tell you a little bit about who the sponsors are so you can research a little bit about them because there's always questions on them. And remind me, somebody this week didn't get
that happened once before.
I know.
But we switched to the Google Voice and then we've never had an issue with it before.
I think we did. We'll see. It might just because I'm doing it back to back.
Overloads it.
The only thing
or if you just
want
to text Lauren to chat about anything.
Yeah, so 223-2030.
You can text us at any time.
223-2032.
Doesn't have to be about trivia.
And this is the number that you're going to text if you win tonight, but we'll put it up later. Less than a minute left. All I ask of you is that you do not cheat, please. No Googling it. Somebody in the room can tell you as long as they're not Googling it.
Wash your hands, wear a mask.
Definitely wear a
mask.
Spay
and pet your neuter.
Spay and neuter your pets. Folks.
I'm only out of half a beer. That's just my tongue. It's not me.
Yes, please do all that stuff.
Oh my god, we have to show them your mask. Maybe in between two games.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Laura got the best mask I've ever seen.
I did.
That's sweet.
And I'm sorry, I'm just catching up here.
We got some text messages.
10 seconds.
You know what I always mess up? I was like, why does the room code desert? I mean desert. When I saw it, I always get 1S and 2S messed up.
All right. Well, if you watched our Instagram, you would know that I literally directed you exactly where to go so you could find out the answer to this question. Which of the following is not a name of a member of the Glazer
Group? I know the answer. Is it Chris, James, Joseph, or Wendy?
Nikki was asking about scavenger hunt info. I can, I'll send you the info, Nikki.
Did we give those three out to the first three people the other week?
We did, but I will,
we need to get her the code.
I emailed them. I'm not sure, I don't remember who was in the top three, but, I will. The company that does it is, River City Food Tours.
Just the company.
Is yep. The company, and they have different ones.
And they have a Discover Food box where on Sundays they'll just drop off a box of all this cool stuff from Richmond, food related stuff. It doesn't help us, we're just trying to help them out. So yeah, just Google River City Food Tours, they'll have all that info there. I'm shocked at how poor people did on this. So the answer is which is not a member.
I capitalize not.
Not part of the Glazer Group. There's only five of us. Well, I guess on like the
plus
realtor side, not the like the marketing back end.
Let's see what my friend said.
Joseph, you need to like be on our Instagram more. People don't even know you exist.
Well,
Wendy, I understand because Wendy's more behind the scenes, so you'd only know her if you did like a deal with us. Poor
so,
JoJo.
Chris.
Who's Chris?
Can we don't know.
He's not on the team.
Here,
not
I guess
yet.
If I go like this,
we don't know anyone named Chris on our
team. Yeah, so Chris is not a member of the Glazer Group team. If your name is Chris and you want to join our team, I'll think about it.
We're not taking applications though.
No, we're not.
Yeah, it's better when they think they can't apply and then it makes them want it more.
Ooh. Like they work a little harder.
Yeah.
Cool. Alright, so there we go. So 26% of you
check out our website.
There we go. Can I make this brighter?
Yeah.
There we go. Perfect. All right, let's see what kind of names we got. This is my favorite part. Miss Margaret gets to pick the best team name. Trivia Masu. By the way, I did ask Margaret what her favorite dessert in the whole world was.
Was it tiramisu?
She said ice cream or tiramisu. Chelsea, the room code. Can you put the room code up? It's
Glazer
Group.
Right here.
crowd.live/Glazer Group. crowd.live/Glazer Group. Okay. Glazer's biggest flan?
Flan.
Dr. Fau cheesecake. All right, I'm gonna come back to these after like five questions because I could just be here all night. And you know how
Dr. Fau.
You know how Alex gets when
worry that we're dragging it on and they're like bored of because we're not as entertaining as we think we are.
They would not come back if they were bored.
Someone's a big Fauci fan. Well,
I'm
probably
also
saw
a big
that
Fauci fan.
It's won before, but Lauren's not picking this week.
Which publication has recognized the Glazer Group as one of Richmond's best real estate agents for 4 years in a row? And look, that's our picture.
We were in it 7 years in a row, but it still applies.
According to our website, it only says the last...
because we were number one a couple years in a row. All right.
If he wants to write the questions...
I have to do the technical side and like sell houses.
I know, I'm just messing with you. I got these earrings off Amazon for $7 and I'm actually kind of digging them.
Oh, I like that there's a team photo up. Oh, I forgot I need to put something there so it's not
so
on the YouTube.
On the far left is James, and then we have Wendy, and then Joseph's in the middle, and then you can tell maybe you could recognize us on the other side.
Back
there.
When we were both skinny and neither of us had beards.
I
she just
did
bleached
not have
or shaved
beard
her
then.
Recently. Yeah.
I'm trying to. I feel like I'm like
falling
very
off.
Out of
frame.
Okay.
You just turned the.
Oh, all right.
right, it's fine. Just keep going.
It's fine.
Just keep going.
Style Weekly is the answer. At least half of you knew.
Yay!
I know. Matt says every week he thinks his name game is strong, and then he reads them all. Wendy was photoshopped in. Actually, this whole photo was photoshopped together.
Because our photographer says the chance of getting all five of you to smile nicely at the same time is almost impossible.
Oh, there's glazed donut group.
Ooh, that's actually...
Wicked Apple Pie Wop? Stop it!
Lauren's been obsessed with that song.
I sanitize your pies.
Is that song about...
Glazer groupie?
Puppies? Wet-ass puppies?
Harry Potter and the Cobbler of Fire? Moose tracks. Okay. Ooh. Here we go. What's the difference between a tart and a pie?
Tarts are made with butter instead of shortening. Tarts are eaten after lunch, where pies are eaten after dinner. Tarts have crust on the bottom only, whereas pies can have crust on the top and bottom. Tarts are smaller than pies. I was gonna say pops or tarts.
Ooh.
Pop tart.
But they have, well, you don't know the answer.
I'm gonna guess, I would have probably guessed C.
It is C, but pop tarts have crust all around.
But the icing kind of covered, I don't know, you're right. So tarts never have a top. It's just like jelly hanging out.
So is it technically a pumpkin pie? Is that a pumpkin tart?
I don't know. Unless we get into that with these questions.
Uh-oh. Oh. Truffle shuffle.
The war.
Of northern ingestion. Dove chocolate is manufactured by which company?
Mars, Hershey, Betty Crocker, Nestle, or Dove Soap is what I would have said.
I almost put that in there, but I'm like...
I totally would have said Dove Soap if that was one of the answers. 100%. Is anyone else with me? It's too logical. It's like, why?
Also, 100% of questions this week are dessert related.
Lauren.
I know, but it's too late. We gotta keep it to next one. It's already 7:45.
All right.
We're at 99 players, y'all. So if we get to 100 the next game, I gave them until the countdown.
We give you 3 extra minutes this week.
I probably should have. Nobody said Betty Crocker. So
is that who it is?
No.
Oh.
It's Mars. I had to add that one in there. I'm like, I don't know. The hardest part of trivia is coming up with the wrong answers. Cakealicious.
Andrew, if you're ever bored and want to help us one week.
Wait, what? No, he's got his own job to do, Alex. He told me he stopped doing trivia.
Told me that he enjoyed doing it and didn't want to give up a week. So
this upside down French dessert, primarily made of apples and a pastry crust, was invented by two sisters.
Pie apple upside down.
I came up with that.
Tart tatin, apple cobbler, or French apple cakes.
I just gave away the what was
pie apple upside down apple pie.
Pie
did
apple. Like pineapple upside down, but it's pineapple.
I would love to just write questions. If you're serious, we'll DM later.
Oh, so he does the write, we do the presentation?
We might be able to do some compensation. I make a lot of cider.
It is a tart tatine. That's how I pronounce it.
Alex, Margaret, too.
Alex, what, would love to just write questions?
Yeah. You can't play that week, but... we'll talk later. They get 100% and win all the prizes. Yeah, I'll write all the questions. All right. Tartan?
Tartatine.
Tartatine?
All right, we're at five questions in. Miss Margaret,
Alex brings
can you
home
see,
the what?
Miss Margaret,
candy
can you
bacon.
See all the names? Because she gets to pick. Winning trivia is the icing on top.
I think it
shows
up different on your answering device than it does on YouTube.
Well, there scrolls through like that, I think.
Are you ready for trivia, Oreo?
How did the chicken croissant the road?
$8 and $1 pastry.
Wop.
Yeah. WAP is trending hard.
Oreo ready for trivia.
Glazer groupie.
To Kill a Macaroon. Strawberry fat cake.
Wait, I can make this bigger. Bigger. Nope. Okay, maybe here. There we go. Ah, now I don't need to squint so hard to look at the screen.
All emojis.
All emojis.
Hey, JJ. Are you wearing your Glazer Group shirt?
It's back, baby. Yeet.
Boston Cream Pie Massacre. Cake by the ocean. Ooh. Okay, here we go. We're moving on. The word dessert originated from the French word desservir.
Meaning a large land of just sand. To finish the meal, to sit and chat, to enjoy sweet things, to clear the table. You came up with three of those? Those are all, like, I would guess any of those.
Yeah.
Proud of you. Or did you just find, like, a dessert quiz that had all four answers?
Mm-mm.
I don't know.
Sometimes I get lucky, but...
He's wearing the shirt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh.
You like when you, like, get a
I like
good
when I,
spread?
Yeah.
To clear the table.
To clear the table.
Are you sure it's not a large area of sand?
That's
hot,
the
hot, arid, sandy area?
That's the Sahara Desert.
Okay. Is it the Pacific or Specific Ocean?
I don't know if I said this last week, but obviously last week was Shark Week, and the whole time I was like, don't type shark. I was like, I'm not taking a shot.
A shot for a shark for instead of a shark.
National Pi Day is celebrated on January 23rd. Aww. On what day do we celebrate Pi Day?
Oh, March 13th, April 14th, March 14th, April 15th.
I remember celebrating this in school.
I know. It was awesome. We got U-crops.
Yeah, we did.
Like the little tarts. Were they tarts or were they pies?
Were they tartatine?
So like if it was a little circle like coconut... Or like the chocolate. Mm. I guess it's still all called pie. I guess it doesn't need fruit to be a tart. Probably.
According to this, a tart is just this crust on the bottom.
But I still think there needs to be fruit.
Isn't all pie fruit?
Chocolate pie's not. Coconut pie's not.
Coconut's a fruit.
Alright, chocolate pie's not. Is chocolate technically a fruit? Probably.
Yeah, because it's a cocoa bean, yeah.
Alright, meat pie.
Chicken pot pie. Pumpkin pie. Love me some pumpkin pie.
I think it's 3.14.
159. I tricked some of you guys.
Because they're trying to answer quick.
I know. That's what I meant to say. I need to write this on here. The quicker you answer, the more points you get. But I'm sure people
want
do that.
A pen?
Gosh, I love shepherd's pie so much. I made a tomato pie last week.
And I was like, that's just pizza.
This is my... good food fist, like, yes.
I was like, Lauren, you made a pizza. It was just crust, tomatoes, and cheese.
Yeah, he was like, this is like a
but
pizza.
It honestly might be better than any pizza I've ever had. Not downgrading, you know, Pizza Bones or Zorch or any of those others.
He told me I needed to start a restaurant to sell tomato pie.
Well, you can't call it that. It's called pizza and people get, okay. We interviewed Rob Zorch and he said he got started by making this pie. I think we asked a question about it months ago. That had a pie crust. It was like a Pittsburgh. And I wonder if that's similar to what he made in Pittsburgh. From Pittsburgh.
Mm. I know. 100 players.
But did Lauren say we had to do it before we started? Well, there's not 100 players on the leaderboard. It only goes to 95. I don't understand this crazy device.
Let me think about it. Give me the question.
If we can hit 100 again, then definitely.
Yeah, I agree with that.
There's a fly.
I
honestly 95 too.
Okay, this custard is Italian for cooked cream.
Panna cotta, flan, pudding, or creme brulee.
I know. Somebody put some Z's. I'm sorry if you're sleepy.
What?
Well, I don't know. I do think next round is better. More fun.
Why?
I don't know. Just better questions. It does say 100 players. All right, fine. You're right.
But where are they?
I don't know. We're getting there. Panna cotta. Good job, guys. All right, when making cakes, what did people use before whisks were invented?
They obviously used nothing. Put it in the oven. A bundle of twigs. That's where you got that crunch. Uh-huh. Their bare hands.
They just went like this.
It'd have to be like a really big like feather. One. Maybe not like a handful of like down feathers, but just like got really feathery.
You know, sometimes my gut
was, I was about to yell it, and I was like, maybe I shouldn't. It was bare hands, just cake.
Apparently, a lot of other people thought so too, but it turns out that
a bundle of twigs.
A bundle of twigs. They really liked apple trees, apparently.
But how did they not break? Because they had to be like at least somewhat thick.
I mean, you have to I don't know.
The pie who loved me.
All Hershey Kisses have a white paper strip that comes out of the top of the wrapper. Do you know what it's called?
A ribbon, a dangle, a plume, or a crown.
Oh, confused cakes. Yeah, it would just give it a little crunch.
Stuff got in it, yeah.
I mean, but you, to be honest, like if they didn't have whisks, they probably didn't have soap to wash their dishes, so you're probably eating dirt anyway.
What's dirtier, a twig or your hand?
Your hand? In my opinion, I mean, your hand.
I don't know. Like, I guess it's clean, but I use a giant twig to when I mash beer. It's just a huge stick that's...
It's called a plume.
Clean, though.
Hershey's, they call it a plume, and they did it so that nobody can... No knockoffs. And it helps
unwrap
it.
They, like, copyrighted it or
something like that.
Patented it?
I don't know. Something like that, yeah.
Huh.
Mm-hmm. So, the imposters, you could tell imposters.
I've never seen apart. A knockoff kit. Like, no one's tried.
That shape? I don't know. There's knockoff Reese's cups, and they are not.
I don't know if I've ever had
not,
it.
You've never had a Reese's, like a peanut butter cup
a
that's
Reese's
not.
Frup? A fake? Reese's cup? No, I don't think I have.
All right, so we are one third of the way in. We have Glazed Donut Group in first with 664
like
points.
Like that name.
Carol Dairy Queen in second, and then WAP in third. I am so impressed by everybody that can do that dance on TikTok. I can't stop. It's like enthralling. All right, where did German chocolate...
I like the ones when people fall.
Where did German chocolate cake come from?
Is this a trick question? Germany, France, USA, or Italy? Now I'm overthinking it. It's either A or it's B, C, or D. Because if it's not from Germany, it could be from anywhere. And they're like, this is what we think they eat there. I don't know. You probably have the whole backstory, don't you?
It's from the USA. Good job. I forgot the backstory. But it was somebody... Oh, the guy's name was German. His last name was German.
But he was French in America. No, I don't know what he was.
I told you it was a lot of, where are things from? What is the main flavor in a traditional tiramisu?
Ooh.
Did I spell tiramisu wrong?
No, it's correct. Coffee, hazelnut, dark chocolate, French vanilla. I don't think it'd be a penalty unless people couldn't understand what you were trying to say.
I'm just waiting for
everyone to just.
I don't know. Did I spell it? Oh yeah.
Apparently, it's
there's
not
a picture under
eavesdropping. It's eavesdropping, and I'm like, whoever called it that? Apparently, everybody.
Tira. T I R A M I. I did spell it right.
Good job, babe.
Proud of me.
Alicia.
Coffee. Very good, my friends. Very good.
If we have no errors the whole time, I'll do a shot at the very end just for fun.
It was spelled right, Alicia.
She was just jumping on the bandwagon before we checked spelling.
Oh.
But I don't think that would count.
What? That definitely, what do you mean?
One letter off and you're like, you have to do a shot?
I think it counts.
No. You knew what it was.
Coming from somebody who doesn't know how to spell anything, that's technically right.
I never even
you.
Got the rules from them on what exactly is a penalty. We just kind of adopted it one night because I think they were playing and they yelled at us because we royally messed up, and it was very obvious.
I was a spelling bee champ in third grade too, Alicia. And you know who,
wasn't?
You know who can't even spell the word bee?
Glazer.
B.
What?
How do you spell bee? Like zoo, zoo, zoo.
B-E-E.
Good job.
I was struggling with desert and dessert, and I had to Google it. I'm like, wait, which one has two S's? Like, I
Seriously?
Could spell it.
That's well, like you learned that in, like, fourth grade.
My brain, maybe I'm, like, 1% dyslexic. I see it, and I'm like, is that dessert?
I ask him, like, once a month. I'm like, how did you get accepted to college?
How did I make Dean's List? Spell check.
How did... Sometimes he doesn't know how to spell things, so he'll Google it. And like
Google's
type,
like...
Yeah, sometimes Google's like, I don't even know what you're
Jurassic
trying to say.
Is one that's very hard for me to spell.
Caitlin and I watched Jurassic Park last week. Ask if English is my first language because I can't communicate properly.
So I guess me and Andrew are very simple. Hey, I'm very talented at many things. No one's perfect at everything. Spelling is just not my thing.
Spelling is my thing. I'm passionate about spelling.
I can get by.
Ooh, dessert has an extra S because it's indulgent. I taught him how to spell restaurant.
You also taught me a few other things.
All right, also known as the Black Cow, this dessert got its start in Colorado in a mining camp in 1983. If you were in Trivia Club, you would have the answer to this.
Root beer float, ice cream sandwich, brownie, or licorice? Black Cow. Mm-hmm. I have a guess. I'm going to wait for the time to go down more. I'm going to guess ice cream sandwich because a lot of times... Oh, no, wait. I was thinking of Black Cow and the cow with like black and white on it, which would be like ice cream sandwichy. But now that I think about it, there's solid black cows, so I don't know. Licorice? I'm going to go with B because you kind of like... Are we all wrong? Or is...
Well, 77% of them are correct because it was a trivia club question.
Maybe I should have read the email we sent.
Maybe we should have. just goes to show when I asked him to read it over before we send it out that he literally does not.
No, I read the paragraphs. Why would I like have to check the answer thing? I make sure that the links go to the places they should.
It's okay.
We're good at different things. You couldn't survive with your, like, how to work your own phone without me.
That is a fact.
Yeah.
I have the technological ability of an 80-year-old. So. But I found, I think it's, like, learned helplessness because Alex can do it all.
And I'm like, give it to me. I'm like, threw it.
Yeah, he doesn't even give me a chance.
No, you ask.
Did you turn it off?
Did you turn it off and turn it back on?
And then he says, and then if I said I've done that, then he's like,
you need to factory reset your phone.
Did you factory reset
it? It's been a year,
it?
You complain about it constantly. I swear, as soon as we get a little over a year, our phones just are garbage. And I'm like, I have to wait a whole other year with this crap.
The world we live in. I will say my phone has been
first getting problems.
A lot of loving since
quarantine.
Yeah.
The also, screen has like thumb dents in it, like from swiping. Just... She's cracked the screen 3 times.
I actually only cracked the screen once.
That's because you dropped
came
it.
Came to the house and fixed it for me.
Yeah, they went on their little van and then brought it right back.
Here's an interesting one. Each Oreo contains how many ridges along its edge? And this is per brown cookie. This is in addition to the 12 flowers, 12 dashes, and 12 dots. Apparently this is a well-known
50,
fact
90, 120, or a
$1.44. Oreo people.
Margaret's had the same phone for almost 5 years.
Girl.
You must have the patience of a saint. I don't know. As soon as my phone takes more than 2 seconds to do anything, I'm like, another one.
Also, I don't...
But we live and work on our phones.
I was going to say,
she doesn't like it.
We literally do, like, everything's on our phone. Can you give me... What are you doing? Can you give me Salty? Yeah, everything's on our phone. Okay, so it turns out that there are 90. Look at you, smarty pants. Nikki still has her iPhone 5S. We're Android people, so I don't even know what that, Alex, Alicia wants a seltzer too. Yeah. Alicia.
Okay, tell her we're making some.
Nikki still has an iPhone 5S, but I don't know what that means.
They're on an 11, so that's like 5 or so years old.
Okay. I can't imagine. I... They all just run together. Anyway, 90 ridges along the side.
Alicia, when I saw Richmond Seltzer Company, I got inspired to try my first hard seltzer, so it's brewing right now, or I guess fermenting. I'll share a bottle if it's not terrible.
Andrew says that because we have Androids, it explains the need to constantly upgrade. But if I break my screen, it just costs me $30 instead of $300.
So. I have many of friends that have just given up iPhones. Joseph was one of them. Get whatever phone you like. I don't care. I don't mind buying another one because it's a work expense.
I am too far into the Android family that it would probably take
Google.
Me a decade to learn how to use an iPhone.
Efficiently, the same way that we're at.
Before I moved to Apple, the Sidekick. What is the Sidekick?
It's that phone that would like flip out and it'd have the keyboard underneath. It's like.
You guys remember the walkie-talkie ones?
Yeah.
Razors are making a comeback.
No, they are. They made a new one that was like all touchscreen. So next on the list is the Ardent High Point Double IPA.
It smells really good.
It's very good.
I love a sip of this.
Ardent's been... I don't know. When they first opened, I was like, their IPA game was okay. Now I feel like their IPA game's come around very, very well.
That is phenomenal.
Between this and the Ardent X, they do an eye.
Okay, although it is true that ancient Chinese warlords would send messages hidden inside cakes, fortune cookies are not Chinese. Where were they invented?
Germany. Tokyo, Los Angeles, Seoul, or Albany?
What did you say, Germany?
The German cakes. A couple questions ago.
They were actually made in Fortune.
Fortune, Indiana?
Fortune, Indiana. Iron Man 3. I don't know what that's in reference to.
Me either.
Tell me more, Marissa.
L.A.
L.A. is right, y'all. Hold on. Do you remember my fortune cookie last week, Alex?
Yeah, so... We like to give our fortune cookies to our dogs and read the fortune to them, let them pick it out, and then instead of saying in bed at the end, we say in dog bed.
It's adorable. Mine, I had like a really weird one. Now I want to find it.
And yaps about
now
it?
It's gonna...
What? He yaps about the fortune cookies?
Who?
Apparently in Iron Man 3, the villain talks about where fortune cookies were made.
Oh. My fortune. It said, here we go. Low fat, whole wheat, green tea.
In dog bed.
That was my fortune.
That doesn't make sense.
Here we go.
That was yours, not David's.
Low-fat, whole wheat, green tea, period. I read something recently. It wasn't when I was researching this, but maybe it was. A fortune cookie company successfully predicted lottery numbers, and like 119 people won the lottery somewhere at the same time. And
I'm surprised that many people
split, like,
go with the numbers on the fortune cookies, because that's just as random as the lottery itself.
All right, we're halfway done. So we got glazed donuts in first place with 1105. The War of Northern Ingestion. I wanted to say indigestion because that just relates with me more, but I can go with ingestion as well. And then we got WAP in third.
I saw my name in all caps and I didn't miss it. It was like, Alex something something something. It went by too fast.
Margaret, you looking at all these names, my friend?
So
I don't envy your
job. Go to the end. Is it longer now?
98. Glazer.
So this says 98 and then the other one says 102. Maybe 98 people have answered and there's 4 bots.
Yeah, we don't like bots. I gotta have
at least
100
answer.
People answering. If there's really 100 players, they can stick around for next time. We have 100 for the second.
But what
game.
If we don't get 100 next time?
I don't know. This tube-shaped pastry is deep-fried before a rich filling is inserted into it.
Ooh, a Twinkie, a spumoni, ladyfinger, or cannoli?
Patrick says that they started in San Francisco, so now I'm just questioning everything, Patrick.
But you found that on Google. This wasn't CrowdPur, so you'd think that if anyone needs to take a shot, it was the New York Times.
We'll figure it out.
I was thinking cannoli. But now I'm wondering if it's a Twinkie.
Cannoli is the right answer. I threw Twinkie in there because it's a rich filling. A Twinkie's filling is not rich.
It's cheap.
I learned something about Twinkies too.
That they'll survive a nuclear bomb with cockroaches?
Will they?
That's the rumor. I don't think they will. They have an expiration date. But I guess everything has to.
I would rather eat a Twinkie than like dried beans or whatever. Wait, a Twinkie or a cannoli, Nikki? Which one's your favorite? Because that's a lot of E's at favorite, and so that means, like, real favorite.
That means, like, this.
I guess a cannoli. Do you remember when we went to New York City this last time and we got... Boston. Did we get a... Oh, was it Boston? We got cannolis. We went to some dessert...
Boston cream pies and like all that stuff.
Yeah, we went to some dessert place and got like 6 takeout desserts and ate them on our
hotel. Well, we went to the one that had all the reviews and the line was like around the block.
Yeah, we were like, no.
And I just Googled and there was another one block away and it was, we didn't try the other place, but it was phenomenal and I feel like all the tourists go to that one and then all the other ones are just as good.
Ayana says that her phone said 100% got the question right. Y'all, it's 2020. I don't have answers for anything anymore. I'm not gonna make an excuse because I don't have one, and there's no answer.
100% of people got that question right. Who knows? Alex brings up the candy. Okay, that's what it was.
All right, here we go. The Cheesecake Factory boasts a 21-page menu, and this is. Also, they have a 2-page Skinnylicious menu. How many menu items do they offer?
What? A hundo, 250, 400, over 1,000. That's insane no matter what the answer is. I'm going to go with 100 because if it's more than that, that's crazy. I always like to guess the most or the least.
Alicia lost power. Oh no. Wait, what's your guess?
100. I like to guess the most or the least. So that's like my strategy, but it's not really a good one.
Apparently, everything, well, except their cheesecake, everything is made in-house. All of the 250 items that they have.
Except the cheesecake?
Well, the cheesecake, yeah, they don't make the cheesecake restaurant.
But they make it in company. Yes. And then ship it.
Yeah. But everything else they make in-house. And I guess that they have to get there at like 6 a.m. and start cooking.
Proud of them. It is an overwhelming menu.
Yeah, it's freaking spiral bound. That's like... Also, I read a lot of... Okay, I got down a deep, deep, deep Cheesecake Factory hole. So you know they have that really good brown bread?
I think. It's been so long since I've been
to one. It's like the good brown bread, like an Outback type thing in the bread bowl. Yeah. But I guess you can like ask them to like make a sandwich out of it and like...
But you were like secret menuing it?
Yeah, like, people are like really on this Cheesecake Factory train. I don't get it. I like it. I like their food more than I like their cheesecake, but I still like their cheesecake.
Or are you registered to vote?
No way, is that one?
Pie Felicia? Yes.
Pie Felicia?
Pie Felicia.
Wait, so Margaret, you can't see these names or you said yes? She said, wait, I have a yes and then I didn't.
I think she maybe was talking about, I don't know.
I don't know. Margaret, let me know, because I'll screenshot them.
Yeah, the leaderboard only says 98.
All right, what are the two main ingredients in buttercream frosting? Margaret can only see the 95. Yeah.
Butter and cream. Powdered sugar and cream. Mayonnaise and powdered sugar. Butter and powdered sugar.
So, Margaret, same for us. I think it's because the other 5 haven't answered any questions.
They're
so
bots.
For that reason, I cannot give you guys... cannot give out $100 unless I have 100 people answer questions. On the leaderboard. I don't know. We need to figure this out.
We can call CrowdPro tomorrow or Google their FAQ.
We'll do it this time.
I'm going to email myself now.
We'll do it this time.
So we won't forget.
But know that next time we're making a hard rule. Hard rule.
Wait, oh, we're going to give out the money.
We'll give out the money now.
Okay.
But next time.
Next time, we got to figure out the tech support.
Mm-hmm. 100 because there are doubles of some placements. Oh, like people have the same amount of points. Jessica.
Wait.
Yes, that's exact. Like, so if somebody has both, two people have 50 points.
Are trivia players as smarty pants as we think they are?
Well, I don't know. Hold on.
Can you find one that's doubled?
Yeah, let me see.
Let me just try the top. Oh.
Yeah, RVAX did tell people to play. All right, we got to keep this going. Oh gosh, Alex is going to be real mad at me.
I'm not saying anything this time.
Okay, all right.
I wanted to see how it'd go if I didn't push you along.
Okay, well, you keep talking, so be quiet.
Oh, now it's my fault.
Okay, all right, sorry. Okay, what does the name M&M stand for? This was really interesting to me, too.
Moons and Mars. Mars and Murray. Matcha and milk. Milton and Murray.
No.
I was going to guess Mike and Mary. But that wasn't one of the answers.
I thought so, too, Nikki.
Well, we started 3 minutes late on purpose. We can blame on that.
Ooh, it is Mars and Murray. Apparently that's the names of people.
Do you want me to take over and make sure we end by 8:30?
Mm-mm.
Okay. We'll just make the second round late players.
Can you stop talking? This cake, made with very little, if any, flour at all, is often made up of several layers and filling. I'm trying to keep going, and every time I start a question, before I can read it, you try and, like, say something. I know. Get us out of this house, please, somebody. Please, wear your mask. Stop the coronavirus so I can leave for like a day. I just need to go somewhere. Anywhere.
You can go places, it's just you might die later. It's fine. No big deal.
It's fine.
Stop being a little, you know what?
A tort. A tort. A little tort.
A little tort.
Tort.
Stop being a tort.
That's some wet ass tort.
You see, you had 36 cases this week.
This very sweet dessert is made from phyllo pastry and is eaten mostly in Greek restaurants. What is it?
Ooh.
What is it?
Ooh, is it spanakopita?
I saw that, Margaret. They had 25 Bulgasta.
Students. Lokma or baklava.
I almost erased this question, but then I wanted to hear you pronounce it.
What? The bugasta?
Yeah,
this?
VCU.
I know spanakopita.
Had 25 Lokma. Students and 11 faculty
Teachers
and staff. And... But I saw Stony just put out a request that they... colleges, including VCU,
64,000
in a day. No, Stony put out a request that mandatory for all students to download the COVID tracking app.
I downloaded it.
Baklava. You love baklava, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
He loves baklava.
It's like lava on your back. That's
sounds
what it lava
painful.
Baklava. Sounds delicious.
Painful. Okay, I'm going real fast. Which ingredient is excluded from angel food cake, allowing it to be light and airy?
Excluded.
Yeah, so it's
vanilla,
purposely...
egg whites, brown sugar, egg yolks.
So, I guess angel food cake's kind of like a sponge cake, but with angel food cake,
it's missing this ingredient.
This out to keep it so light and airy, like an angel or an angle
so
food cake.
As soon as it gets zero, you can hit the next button, and then the next button.
Like this?
Yep.
Egg yolks?
Egg yolks.
Look at you guys.
Look
proud
at you guys
you.
Go.
Okay, here we go.
All of a sudden, it's speed rounds. Look, you're wasting time.
This dessert, like a crepe, can be filled with sweet ingredients to make it a dessert or meat to make it part of a lunch or dinner.
Forgot we had to read the question first.
Yeah.
Beignets. Ooh. Blintz. Lakis. Lach.
Wait, what's your second favorite dessert, Nikki? We're going so fast, I don't know anymore.
I'm letting you take your time and...
Okay, run tight. Okay, no, I need your...
But you always complain when I try to help.
Baklava? No, I don't complain. I just give it
latkes.
I just give you a hard time.
They're like
fried
potato pancakes. They're so good.
I think she's making fun of the way you say it.
Latkes.
I'm Jewish,
but I'm not Jewish. Like, I'm Jewish by blood, but I have no training to pronounce. All right,
where did Black Forest cake come from?
United States, Germany, Canada, Russia.
I bet it is pretty easy to make.
What, baklava or latkes?
Baklava. I made my own crust for my tomato pie. That was good. I think that's what made it so good.
Is that a, like, team name?
No, it was Blintz. I think he's doing a joke. I think he's making it funny. How do you guys know Black Forest cake is from Germany, but German chocolate cake is not? Where was the Danish pastry born?
Oh, I was going to be like, Danish.
Denmark?
Denmark. Hamburg, Copenhagen, Amsterdam, Vienna.
So Hamburg is in Germany, Copenhagen, Amsterdam, Vienna.
Wait, you're just giving them answers? Like,
no, I'm telling, like, the countries. So it's not all, they're not all, not Denmark. Fun fact!
The second worst thing after spelling is my geography.
That definitely me. Me too. So, fun fact, Vienna. So, I guess, in Denmark, all the... I just did that one.
In you can Denmark, talk and button.
In Denmark, all the workers went on strike, and so the bakeries hired people people from Vienna, and they came over and they brought the.
Blazer's biggest fan. I like the flan.
Bananas Foster is an American dessert that originated in what city?
Nashville, New York City, New Orleans, San Francisco, Bananaville.
I love Bananas Foster.
That's the one where they set on fire.
Mm-hmm. At your table, they roll it out and they just go.
If I had to guess, I feel for some reason, it's probably wrong, but like New Orleans would set shit on fire, the stuff on fire.
You're right.
Other people agree.
You're right.
Delicious.
All right, I'm getting here. I'm getting through, guys. Which Italian dessert is often thought of as egg punch and contains Marsala wine?
Raspberry. Pavlova, eggnog, tiramisu,
Zabaglione.
You should have just let me try.
I don't know how to say it.
I was close.
No, I was trying to pronounce it. I don't know.
How would you do the first one? Raspberry pavlova?
I would say pavlova.
Pavlova.
Because it's
just where do you emphasize certain words or letters?
Zagliablablabla is the right answer. Gummy worms were introduced to the market when?
65, 77, 81, or 89. You love gummies. Does anyone else have a tub of candy next to their bed and they call it bed candy and they just eat it at night? I said anyone else.
Oh, I was putting a finger down.
Oh.
Oh, Haribo Twin Snakes? Yes! Anybody else like the colas? The little Coke bottle? Margaret likes that idea.
Gummy worms?
All right, Patrick. I appreciate your input here.
81. I guess everything else before then was just called something different. Christmas and Easter. All
right, two questions left. As per NASA...
Is that a picture? Blank is the most missed item by astronauts in space. Second is pizza. And third are fizzy drinks. Oh, it's a sad astronaut?
Yeah.
Did you add that? Or was
yeah,
that
I added it.
Oh.
Oxygen.
No, wait, they have that. Gravity.
So my candy trick is just add all different candies to one big thing. And so it's like a surprise what you're getting because it's by your bed, so it's like in the dark and you're just like, what do I get? I guess this is what I'm meant to have right now.
And then as it gets low, she refreshes it, so it's always like changing. It's like trail mix for
all right
not
so
skinny.
Yeah. What do NASA what do they
apple
miss
pie
most?
Cheesecake, Girl Scout cookies, ice cream. The most item, I would say my wife.
That was what you would miss the most.
Yeah.
And then pizza. And then fizzy drinks?
No, it would be ZZQ.
Wait, I didn't think you couldn't have fizzy drinks in space. I never really thought about it.
I'm going to go with ice cream because you always, as a kid, were like,
you're right.
Astronaut ice cream, and then you eat it, and you're like, this is highly disappointing.
Not the same.
Highly disappointing.
All right, last question. I'm going to finish before 8:25. Dallas McKinnon did the original Snap, Crackle, and Pop voices for Rice Krispies. In addition, he was also the original voice for what other product mascot?
Was it Tony the Tiger, Toucan Sam, Count Chocula, the Trix Rabbit? Alicia.
You're so nice.
I think we both gained a COVID-19. Yeah. And I know that because I tried to put on my suit and I started
19 pounds down, so I'm like.
So she's back to par.
I'm back to my normal fat. I haven't gotten above my normal fat yet. Yeah, everybody has, right? All right, here we go. Are we ready, my friends? Can you put up the phone number, please?
So did we decide, are we doing the hundo?
Yeah, we're going to do it. We're going to do
it. But what if we hit 100 again in the next one? Like, literally the next one. Just wait and see.
Hopefully we
do.
Yeah, hopefully
we do. We like having players.
All right, so coming up, first place, you get a $50 gift card to Shindig. Second, $25 to Shindig. Third place, $25 cold hard cash. Or not third place, random. So if you are one of these winners, you are going to text us at this number, 804-223-2032. Are we ready?
So
they have an answer. Oh, yeah, they did answer. Sorry. It was Tony the Tiger. Good job, guys. All right, so first place, we have Glazer's Biggest Flan.
Congratulations.
Can you...
But see, how do we do the numbers? To 98?
Do it to 98, I guess.
But that's not... So is there a duplicate?
I don't know right now, Alex, but we'll figure it out. We will figure it out.
I'm just looking.
I need to take a picture of this so I can remember it in the morning. So Glazer's Biggest Flan, if you could text us, 804-223-2032. The War of Northern Ingestion.
Congratulations.
Please text us as well.
$5 gift card.
All right. Number 5. Wicked Apple Pie. Whop.
What?
You get $25 cash. Congratulations. There is a duplicate. Okay. All right. So, Whop gets $25. Can you put that down, please? We have to give away these $20. And it's
part of the show.
I know, but I need a pen. I'm really stressed out today. This is not a good day.
This is all recorded. You can watch it later.
I don't want to watch it later. Have you ever tried to watch yourself the next morning? It's awful.
We got Biggest Flan text. Thank you.
Okay. Now, 1 through 98 for this hundo. Hundo dollars. We're going to give you $20 each. Ready?
Hold on. 1 through 98.
Oh, Margaret Mary has given you her favorite team name.
So far, but we give, or no, wait.
The Pie Who Loved Me, Truffle Shuffle, When It Rains It S'mores, and To Kill a Macaroon. Love those.
But the winner's chosen at the 8:30 game.
They know.
Okay. So if you want to change your name, if you're like, man, these other names are really good, let me think of a better one real quick. You can. You have between 4 and 12 minutes to do so.
Okay, so we're about to do your Venmos. So, numbers.
We're just giving out money, right?
Yep.
Number 42.
Number 42. Who's my number 42? Harry Potter and the Cobbler of Fire. Text me. I'll Venmo you $20 tomorrow morning.
Number 11.
Number 11. Winning trivia is the icing on top. Text me. I'll Venmo you $20 tomorrow morning.
Number 80.
Ooh. Amy and Connor, number 80. Text me, and I will Venmo you $20 tomorrow morning.
Number 52. Sorry, I wanted to build a little anticipation.
52. Boston Cream Pie Massacre. Text me.
Last but not least, 92.
Emily Durr.
Durr.
Pie Felicia. Sorry, you didn't win Pie Felicia.
We just like that name.
Emily Durr, you did. So, I have 42, 11, 80, 52, 92. If you text me, I will Venmo you $20 tomorrow morning because we hit 100 players.
Did you take a picture of all those shirts, the team names down for those numbers before we like skip over?
No, because I can go in at the end and see.
You can go later. Okay.
All right.
So, we got number 11. I guess we should leave the number up. If you're joining us for the 8:30 game, it'll be starting any second.
Emily, got your text.
If y'all want to start jumping over to the new room for the second game, We're getting texts like crazy. Proper Pie is the room code. Just keep it on the same YouTube. No need to change that. Just hop in, go to Crowd.live, Proper Pie, or go to Crowd.live and then enter Proper Pie. Both do the same thing. So we got number 11. We got Amy and Connor. I wasn't paying attention to whatever more. Boston Cream Pie Massacre, 52. Emily Durr, congratulations, you got $20. Wop, Wicked Apple Pie, got yours. Glazer's Biggest Flan. Love your trivia. Aw, thank you. Pumpernickel, and it's made with chocolate. I don't know what that's in reference to. Maybe I'm out of the loop. Someone sent us an email and said my name is Connor, but what was your trivia name and or number? I'm lost without Lauren. My name is Connor. Is that the team name?
What?
No way.
What?
Oh, it's for the email list. Thank you, Connor.
Okay.
The bread is pumpernickel. I don't know. I'm getting confused by all these texts.
All right, so are we in... Oh. If we... I'm going to stop this.
My mom texted her class at VCU to play... I'll try to get her to give them extra credit for playing.
Aw, that's awesome. So the only time we can get, so we have 51 players so far. So if we reach 100 this game, I'm only giving you $100 if we have 100 people on the leaderboard.
But was it because there was duplicates?
I didn't see any duplicates.
You went through and there's no numbers doubled.
I'll do it. I'll meticulously do it right now.
Okay.
But
I'll start the minute counter. Did you start it?
I can't. Well, I'm in the old one though.
Oh, and you can't do both at the same time?
I don't think so.
I could probably do it on my phone. Or start the counter and then go back over.
Give me like 30 seconds.
I love this
song. I
don't
see any duplicates. But I know that's happened before.
That happened last time, but then we ended up with 100 on the leaderboard.
There were two at the same score.
But wouldn't that put them at the same place, which would therefore make it look like
there was less?
But
it wasn't. It was like if two people had the same amount of points, it just would number them two different things. All right, I'm going to start my 8-minute countdown. We do this every week, and every week I still feel like it's like...
What?
I don't know.
What?
It's like it's like, well, something's not...
lollygag through the whole game and then rush through the last 10 questions. And then on the 8:30 game, we can take our time because there's not another game to start.
I know.
But maybe people like the lollygagging. I don't know. Or they got other stuff to do and they're like, hurry up. No one said that yet. What's
somebody,
the rush?
Somebody did put a bunch of Z's, so...
Like they were snoring?
I don't know. That hurt my feelings, so whoever you are...
Well, you
are,
don't know
by...
what... It, you don't know the reference.
No, I know. I'm just kidding. It didn't hurt my feelings.
Maybe that was...
I don't have any feelings because I've been in quarantine for 4, 6, I don't know how many months.
March to April, April to May, May to June, June to July, July to August. 5.
Oh, it's only been 5.
5 months.
Dave says wrap it up.
Wrap what up?
He's messing with you. All right.
No, I think he's messing with you.
I don't. You can't mess with me.
So, if you did not make the first game and you're wondering, who the heck are these people? What's the Glazer Group? We are local real estate agents.
We don't even know who I am anymore.
Love Richmond. When quarantine started, our marketing plan got really screwed up because we couldn't make cool videos about Richmond through our Why Richmond is Awesome brand. So, we started doing this. But if you have even thinking about selling a house or moving, you're worried because
of
the pandemic.
Or buying a house.
I was really worried when the pandemic started. And then about a month in, everyone was like, we still need to live somewhere. And it's been the craziest year ever in real estate. We've almost helped 100 families move.
If buying a house was not wearing a mask.
Interest rates are below 3%.
Normal.
And inventory is the lowest maybe ever in the last like 20, 30 years in Richmond. So if you were thinking about selling a house, there's never been a better time because prices are at an all-time 69 high.
69 players.
Prices are at an all-time high, way higher than 2007, and inventory is at an all-time low, lower than 2007, and interest rates are also the lowest they've literally ever been. So if you have any questions about real estate, I know we like to have fun and goof off on here, but we take our jobs very, very serious.
So
text us.
Andrew says that if people like the YouTube live stream, that we get promoted and show up more regularly on people's recommended videos. So if you want to like this video, that'd be great.
Oh.
Did you talk about Trivia Club yet?
No. Just popped up. Talk about it now.
Oh. So, Trivia Club. It's a club. We play trivia.
We give you free answers.
We do. We send an email. An email and or a text or both, whichever you prefer, every week on Thursdays to, one, remind you of trivia.
Thanks, Dave.
And then, two, to we give you a free hint, a free clue to one for each game. And then we also let you know who the sponsors are because there's always at least one question on so you can do a little research if that's what you're into.
If you're not following us on Instagram and if you're not in Trivia Club, you're at a severe disadvantage.
Do you need to put our Insta up?
Sure.
So down here, at @WhyRichmondIsAwesome is our Instagram handle. It is that because we are trying to showcase Richmond because as realtors, we want people to move here and stay here.
Point straight at the camera. Also, subscribe on YouTube and it'll notify you when we post new cool videos. And if you forgot it was Thursday, it'll notify you when we go live. We pop it up around 7. We come on around 7:15. So it gives you plenty of time to get notified and, you know, hurry up and eat dinner and join us.
I subscribed 2 weeks ago and it...
you like it?
I love it.
Because you're in the other room and you're like, oh, I better...
And I'm like, oh, I need to get going. Let's see. You talked about who
I'm going to put the shindigs away so we can eat it later.
So prizes for this week. Game is Proper Pie Company. So first place gets $50 to Proper Pie, second place gets $25 to Proper Pie, and then the random winner between third and last also gets $25 to Proper Pie, courtesy of Proper Pie, and they were chosen by our Trivia Player of the Week, Margaret. And let me just tell you a little bit about her as well. Here we go. She has been playing trivia with us for a couple months. She is a sophomore at Mary Washington, majoring in psychology, and her goal is to be a teacher. She loves to travel, and trivia has been the highlight of her week, and she loves tiramisu and ice cream. I sound like I'm like a speed dating coach, but I'm not. That's all I know about her, but she's awesome. I do know that. So she picked the theme dessert week. She picked shindigs and proper pie for us. And so if anybody is new here, the best way to play is to have two devices. One, like your computer, laptop, TV, something to watch us here on YouTube live like you are right now. And then a second device, like your phone to play the game. And to do that, you go to crowd.live. The room code for this game is proper pie, or if you just go to crowd.live/properpie, that will take you straight in. Margaret, as the player of the week, also gets to pick the best team name, and we like to do punny stuff here, so since it's dessert week, do it accordingly. Will you get my mask? I ask of you, please, please, just wear your mask in public. If you're not in public, but still around people, wear your mask. Wash your hands. Alex would like you to spay any of your pets. This is my...
Get there.
Oh, you can't see.
You can see just David.
It's got David faces on it. Hold it. Can you hold it up? What if I do this?
It'll get out of focus. David. Yeah. Is it green? Oh, it's teal. All
right, we got close 82 players. Subscribe on YouTube, wear a mask. I taught you how to.
Proper pie.
Told everybody how to play. We talked about proper pie already.
So, proper pie is.
Also, hold on. As far as how to play, if anybody's new here, the quicker you answer, the more points you get. Also, I did not say this, no cheating. That means no Googling. if it doesn't come out of your brain or somebody's mouth in the room that you're in and they're not Googling it, then, and I don't know, ask Jeevesing it either. Like, that's the same thing. I'm using
I don't think that exists.
As a general term. There's like, we're
no Yahooing or no Binging.
No Binging.
Bing would get the answer wrong.
We're doing this like, as, I don't know. This is for fun, so don't cheat. It's not, come on. If you cheat, then you're kind of, you're probably the person that doesn't wear your mask, so.
Oh.
Burn.
You're savage.
I know. Any questions? Oh, and then anytime you want to talk to us, you can just type in this YouTube chat.
You can also text us, but we're not going to be able to pay attention to too much of the text.
Correct.
During the game, YouTube, but we'll answer after the game. Save our number.
We have 85 players. If we get to 100 and there's 100 people on the leaderboard.
At any point or within 10 seconds? You gave them 8 minutes.
I guess by question.
Three.
Five. Four. We'll do four. We'll split.
Where'd they all go?
No Netscape navigatoring, Dave. Same. All right, which neighborhood is home to Proper Pie Company, RVA's place to get New Zealand-style savory pies and sweet pies, too?
So are the sweet pies New Zealand-style or just the savory?
I think
just the savory.
Yeah, I think New Zealand.
What makes it New Zealand?
I think they're probably the only people that do savory pies. They're just smart. They like savory pie.
Well, if you were part of Trivia Club, you would have known from the newsletter. It would have pointed you, and it would have been very obvious. It was in Church Hill.
I know it's in Church Hill because I did a scavenger hunt from RVA.
We ate there once.
Correct, but it was downpouring, and I was not paying attention to where we were going. But because I did the RVA
River City Food
River
Tour
City
scavenger
Food
hunt
Tour
of Church Hill.
Hunt of Church Hill. Thank you. Then I know that that's where it is, and it's really cute. Really cute.
How cute is it?
Okay. Let me show the leaderboard and then I'll talk. So, COVID has kind of messed with them a little bit. So
they're only open on the weekends.
Right, so they're only open Friday, Saturday,
Sunday.
And I think Sunday. So noon.
12 to 6.
Right.
Pre-orders only.
And then, I think, I don't know if this is, they're just joking, but they say that they will pass your order through the pie hole. So if you get there and there's a line.
We went to Shindig's, and when we were leaving, they had a window that you could also walk up and order to that I didn't realize was there, because the actual Shindig's is closed. You have to go to Shindig's Market, which is super cute.
Do they have all the little stuff in it?
Yeah, like all this really cute stuff.
Oh, I want to go so bad. Joe Biden!
Well, I went, and we were the only ones in the store, and everyone had masks on, and then I washed my hands.
If anybody also is still new here, best team name gets $20, and our player of the week gets to pick
Margaret.
Rest in peace, it's her too.
Guarbecue?
I bought this for Alex maybe a couple weeks ago, because I saw they had new tank tops in, so I bought myself one, and I got him that, and I freaking love that place. Gosh, I freaking love that place. They were hiring, and I was like, I don't need a job, but I want to just...
You have a job.
I don't care.
She wants a different
job. I want that
job. But if it was... She probably would have quit the Glazer Group and gone to work there, but COVID saved it. No. She... Because what would I do? Would you still run trivia?
Yeah, I would do trivia.
Okay. What about all the other stuff you do? Make us hire someone that way more than Rest in Pieces would pay you.
There are six number... Yeah, okay, there are six number... There are a lot of number nines right now.
Then what is it? Holy cow. So it goes
3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3 11333 9999915.
So the blessed one is the number, unless it's double.
Cinnamon bun? You guys are so whisk taker. Oh my gosh, I love you guys. Alex brings home the candied bacon. Pie declare bankruptcy. I see you guys mention us in your stories. I like that. I like that a lot. Preoccupied. Sugar pie, honey. Now watch me whisk. Now watch me. That's a watch me whisk is one of them. I like that.
to kill a macaroon.
I only have That's pies really good. For you. I can only
How did the
be
chicken
happy.
Croissant the road? That took me a second. I was like, wait. How did the chicken croissant
Number
62, the road?
I see you.
I like number 66.
I like number 66 too. Strawberry fat cake? Okay. You got muffin on me. All right, here we go. We ready? Everybody ready? I agree, Marissa. I think it's because it was the first question.
It'll separate out more the more we go.
Tub of bed candy. Hold on. Somebody made their team name Tub of Bed Candy.
Only if you want to give them $20.
I need to give you $20. All right, at the end, Tub of Bed Candy. Text me 804-223-2032.
Don't worry, Margaret. We'll still pick her favorite, but sometimes, like last week, sharks with laser beams in their head, like, it just
Maybe
resonates in your
person.
Soul, and you have to
yeah.
reward that.
Which flavor of pie from Proper Pie Co. did Food Network star Elton Brown say was the best blank pie I've ever had in my life? That's right,
best
ever.
Ever.
That is a literal quote.
From Elton Brown, and if you don't know who he is, he's a... Food Network star. Coconut
but
cream,
he's also very
roasted
like
lamb, pecan
science-y.
Or pumpkin. That's why I like him.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like a scientist that doesn't do science. I just like the answers. Like,
I've started putting like pictures and stuff in because I know you liked it.
Yeah,
that was there. That was on their website.
Do you like it doing it?
I do, but I don't like that I can't see it up there. But it's okay.
There's not really room to put it anywhere. Like
I know.
Take it from there and move it, but I don't know. How,
I
like
know,
where.
But what's annoying is that
but they see
I
it
like
on their
to
phones.
Leave it on here, but then I also crowd rankings.
Do
like
you want a
to
second iPad that's just rankings?
Maybe.
I have another one we can set up right here.
Not right now, but next time. Okay.
I need my leaderboard.
Apparently, if you watched our Instagram and Reddit, I didn't put an arrow next to it because y'all have to do something to earn this. Alright? Pumpkin pie was it. And you know, I don't think we had their pumpkin pie there. What do you think?
I'm pretty sure we did.
Did we? No.
I'm pretty sure I got it because of Elton Brown.
That was like a year ago. That was like 2 years ago.
I know. He said
that
a long time
ago. But now I can't see their stuff. All
right, just keep going. We'll try them. Let me finagle.
Meringue-tang.
Just keep going. I thought you could...
Hostess Malone? I can't.
Wait,
see,
Lauren. There, perfect.
That's too distracting. Pie declare bankruptcy. If I have to see the team names, I'm never gonna move on.
But you have them here.
I know.
But you have to make up your mind. What do you want?
Please me. All right, ice cream that you see in commercials is often what to avoid melting during long production hours?
Play-Doh, mashed potatoes, computer-generated imagery. Huh. Ice cream that's been frozen solid for.
I didn't know that's what CGI stood for.
That's why I was kind of like sitting and thinking. Do I know? I think I would have said computer generated images and not imagery. Probably a little different, but what's the picture of?
It was a kid.
That's tongues for eyes? That's
yeah,
weird.
I know. I know.
Ooh. Food styling buff. I would have gone with mashed potatoes or Play-Doh.
It is mashed potatoes. I didn't know that. I thought that was fascinating. But I had to Google CGI to put that in there. I thought if I added it, the actual words, it made it more official. And people, 1% of persons
You got
it.
Someone.
All right, we got the pie something in first. The pie who loved me in first and then Carol Dairy Queen are tied. And then Tub of Bed Candy.
What's interesting is Carol Dairy Queen's been around for a long time and now their name fits perfect with this
it does.
Week's theme.
Dessert. Carol Dairy Queen.
Tub of Bed Candy.
It's a literal tub.
Should I get it?
Well,
maybe
we can
end.
We can show them at the end. Where did cheesecake come from?
The factory.
Italy, France, Belgium, or Portugal? I'm sorry.
See, when I like see...
Seizure warning.
When I see originate, I'm like, is that spelled right? It's like origin.
Origin?
I don't know. Just see, that's my brain where I like look at it and I'm like, is that spelled right?
That's shot well.
Like, I would have known what it was, but, like, I see it, and I'm like, maybe she misspelled it, but then I'm like, no, that's me.
Last week, he was trying to type choose and chose, and he probably asked me 50 times. He's like, wait.
And then after I did it the next day, I was like, I did it wrong.
He's like, I don't think I did it right. And I'm like, it's fine. He's like, I think it's wrong, Lauren. I'm like, I think I know the difference.
Maybe I have something. There's something going on with my spelling. It's worse than normal.
Is it mental retardation?
I don't know. You tell me. You specialized in that before.
I did. That. Nope, don't come at me because that's a medical term right
She
now.
Did. That's where she got her degree from Longwood, but it wasn't called that.
I did not get a degree in mental retardation.
You're recreational right. therapy.
France. You're right. I didn't know this. I don't know why I didn't know this. Because I guess, so at Italy, Italian places always have the cheesecake or the for dessert.
Yeah.
I didn't see it coming from France. I thought France was like crepes. And what else do French
say? Say crepe. No! All right, say really thin pancakes. All right. No! I won't.
Apple brown Betty.
Pie declare bankruptcy. Let me cake. Proper freaking pie. Cake glazers. Richmond is Jossum's. Holy cannoli.
Also, you guys can't see this, but every time I go to press the button on the iPad, I gotta like wind
zoom
it
in.
Up
and boop. Is there like airplane? You're like,
I can't help it. I'm just like,
All right, which one has the medical diagnosis here?
Ice cream tasters use spoons made of what to be able to taste the product 100% without a slight percentage of aftertaste from typical
what?
Spoons.
No. Gold, plastic, glass, or diamonds? I want a diamond spoon that costs $400,000 to taste ice cream.
Look at Maybe's ear.
Let's do it. I'm going to go with...
This is... So, yeah, okay.
I'm going to go with glass.
So just
I feel like glass is neutral.
A little insight into trivia making. So when I make my trivia, so you know there's two games. So I'll like do a couple
do
questions.
You just Google like
dessert
trivia?
No, I'm not telling you that. Okay. But what I do is when I get my questions, I do like some on one game and then I go to the other game and do like 3 to 5 and then back and forth. And then it's just weird how some games just end up with, like, more interesting questions.
To you? They
to
may
me.
Have loved round one better.
Well, somebody gave a lot of Z's, so I hope
he's
okay.
One person.
I hope he's okay.
He's
this
sleeping.
What I feel...
he's sleeping.
Maybe he's in
it's gotta
a
be glass.
Dessert coma.
Food coma? Yeah.
Most people say glass.
Gold? How does gold have less taste than glass? And what's wrong with your plastic and or just standard metal spoon? Get over yourself.
Slight percentage of aftertaste, Alex.
Ice cream testers? Well, they should test it on a regular spoon because that's how we taste it. Email Ben and Jerry.
Also, hold on. I've got something too. Do they taste it out of a gold bowl? Because if they're eating it out of a glass bowl, is that going to leave a slight aftertaste?
Ice cream. It doesn't matter. It always tastes good.
I'm sure that we can all agree that the worst type of spoon is popsicle stick.
It's free. We need it off that. Pros and cons, babe.
There's no free ice cream if it's.
You don't like the free samples?
What's your favorite ice cream? What's your favorite dessert in the whole entire world? I know it. It's cookies and cream ice cream from Homestead Creamery, probably.
That's favorite dessert ever?
That's
very high up there. Nightingale ice cream sandwiches are very high up there, but so I like the combination of the Nightingale cookie and the ice cream, but Homestead ice cream is just insane. If they could use Homestead ice cream, I don't know if maybe that it wouldn't like ice cream sandwich correctly. I'm sure there's a lot of science to it.
I bought a make your own ice cream sandwich kit from Pampered
but
Chef.
But I love so much stuff. Like I like Rice Krispie treats.
It was not very
I like...
Ooh, Rice Krispie treats. Coconut cream pie.
That cake. Like, the. Do I have to pick?
Which delicious dessert is made from layers of jelly, sponge, fruit, custard, and cream? I think sponge cake. I don't think it's, like, real sponge, but I don't know. Maybe it's a scrub daddy. Is it
Bless you. Which delicious dessert? Oh, wait, you already read it? Flauntra. Sorry, the sneeze got me. I was a little distracted. Zongos? What's the question? Dessert made from jelly, sponge, fruitcake, custard, and cream.
I don't know if you guys know what Zongos are. We call them Zongos. I think they're pronounced like Chongos or something. But it's at Mexican restaurants, and it's literally cheesecake egg roll that they like deep fry. It's cheesecake filling, and then they serve it with a scoop of ice cream. And you got like the hot cheese fried cheesecake.
Here's a bit of Alex and Lauren trivia. So one day when we finally do Alex and Lauren trivia, this will be a question. On Valentine's Day, we always go eat Mexican, either lunch or dinner, and we get a Zongo first.
Always get dessert first.
We never have enough room to eat dessert after we eat normal food ever. So once a year on Valentine's Day, we eat dessert and we eat it first.
Mm-hmm.
And our favorite waiter at Mexico will just bring it. So he's like, oh, Valentine's Day.
Except he's not there anymore and he doesn't return our calls. So
yeah, we're like weird stalk.
Our so waiter. If anybody can like knows
Francisco's.
How to file a missing persons report, that'd be great. Because I'm really worried about him.
No, he's fine.
You're right. It's a trifle. You guys trifling. How come that's not a team name?
I don't know.
All right, we got when it rains, it's
do
s'mores.
Do not panic.
And Bon Bon Jovi. I still like Joe Pye.
Kick me home tonight. I don't wanna know. Don't know all the words. I like Big Bunsen, I do not lie.
What was used to make the chocolate river for the film Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory?
Do I wanna know these options? Sand and dirt, fabric dye, chocolate and cream. Oh my god. Water from the James River right after a huge rain, and they dump the sewer into it.
I almost put after a big storm, but I figured that would be too...
too specific. Yeah. They'll be like, that's not
that's
right.
The, that
but
is,
if you just leave it as standard water from the James River, they'd be like, oh, yeah.
How many bodies do you find in the Chocolate River every year?
How many...
Emily appreciates it. Emily knows.
Just because it looks like chocolate doesn't mean it tastes like chocolate. All right. What's the answer?
Ayana says, thank you. Thank you.
It's
thank
funny
because
it's true.
You.
It looks like, it looks like milk chocolate.
Yeah.
Not dark chocolate.
I almost put a picture of the Chocolate River in here, but I didn't want it. Margaret started wheezing. Yes! Yes! My job is
that
done.
That might
here.
Have been the most best fake answer. Or it's the real answer. I don't know yet. We've ever had. Lauren, I'm going to give you
$20. Yes! Oh my god. It's not Corona.
We got one person picked it probably just for fun.
It turns out it was actually chocolate and cream. And by the end, and a lot of water, but also by the end of filming, it smelled rancid.
How long was it there?
I don't
months?
Know.
Months.
I mean,
months
I don't know. How long does it take to film a movie in the
depends. 70s?
Depends.
A lot of variables.
Depends. I mean, they didn't have to transport it, transport James River water, so.
Oh my god.
I'm just
going
to give myself a little pat on the back there. Whew, all right. What movie contains the infamous line, there's always room for Jell-O? I don't know if that's
Guess
what they
Ghostbusters 2, The Sandlot, Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, or Lean on Me. I don't remember. I've seen all these, but I
don't
remember.
I don't remember this, but apparently it's very well known.
Was it? Did they say it in the movie? There's always room for Jell-O trademark.
Registered.
Quote, question mark.
There's always room for Jell-O. Oh!
Alright, let's answer.
Ghostbusters 2.
Huh. That's the one with the dude in the painting and the, like, the pink slime river? What was that made of?
James River water.
Cotton nose, pink. And
with
thick.
With lots of dead bodies.
It was like cotton candy water. I don't know what else is pink and gooey. Bubblegum water?
Pull that up.
What?
the leaderboard.
Oh, I thought it was too distracting.
I like it now. Yippee pie, yay!
So you can see the top
27. I like that.
Oh, wait, hold on, I can make it longer. You're like, we can stop a top 35.
Bun. Yeah, I like that.
Okay. Keep going.
But now I want that too.
Oh my god.
I know. I'm a tough cookie. I mean, hard to please.
Key lime lover.
Patrick.
Hostess Malone?
I said that already. Patrick Bertoletti holds the world record for eating the most cupcakes in 6 minutes. How many did he eat?
Six.
18?
54. 70? 2. 148.
How many do you think he ate?
606. Whoa. It's changing in live time. The leaderboard, we have it pulled up like that. Normally we don't see
it. How many cupcakes could you eat in 6 minutes?
How many could I or how many should I? Or how many would I? Normally, one's enough, maybe two. I feel like six would be not enough. That's one a minute. It's got to be 18, but it's probably going to be 54. 72 sounds like a lot. I'm going to go C, final answer.
You're wrong. It's 72.
Oh!
I was going through.
Does he have diabetes now?
No, but he's got this whole list of like thing, eating competitions he's won. There's a lot of stuff. Ayana said that...
Were they little ones?
No.
Standard.
Said that... The flower cup he ate in the movie wasn't edible, and it was actually wax. And then I learned that Gene Wilder, he requested to do the somersault into in the scene with where he's like meeting the kids for the first time, because he portrayed his character like as walking with a limp, and they'd never expect it. And the producers were like, "Whatever," and he like did it, and it like was. You remember that
movie history?
Yeah.
It was, as they say, what'd that mean in French? Like, to clear the table?
Yeah, apparently he was like, I guess he knew that role better than they did.
I want to see the picture. Oh. Jesus, Lord.
What?
I don't know, this is PG, this, I guess that's PG-13, he's wearing pants.
Yeah, it's fine, it's fine.
It's just funny because it's ridiculous. I love it.
72 cupcakes. That's
no one said six.
That's a lot. That's what, six dozen?
That's too much math. Alright.
That's a dozen cupcakes a minute?
Excuse you. Yippee pie.
One of the most notorious pie scenes ever. It was from the teen sex comedy American Pie featuring Jason Biggs. What year was the film released?
It's Apple Pie. That should have been the question. 99, 2000, 2001, 2002.
Would you have a guess at this? Because if I thought...
I was in high school, so it could have been literally any of these 4 years. Oh, wait, he was the dad? Mm-hmm. I love Schitt's Creek.
I know, that's why I put him in there.
Keep it real, homies. All right, I'm going to guess 2001. Okay. Is my guess.
Okay. It was 99.
Oh, ouch.
I did not.
Stifler's mom?
For some reason, that seems way older than I imagined it was. 99.
What do you think? It would be like 2005 or something?
I would think like I would guess like 2003 maybe, cause 90 I wasn't even in high school in 99.
I was a 8th or 9th grade, I don't know.
Correct, Nikki. Same. I also should not have been watching that in 99. But also, I don't think our parents knew like
they would show one scene of boobs. Or you mean all the sexual innuendos?
Yeah. Okay.
Inside of windows. What is it? Innuendo.
In.
Urindurindo.
I don't think it was the boobs.
For the dudes.
Boobs are in every movie. It's the everything else.
The strong sexual
Dave
suggestion.
Dave says it's into windows.
Yeah.
The sexual into windows.
I know it at least starts with an E, innuendo.
Innuendo.
Like you're insinuating.
I don't think it starts with an E. You're insinuating. I think it starts with an I. I-N-N-U-E-N-D-O. All right,
whatever.
Innuendo. What, now you're embarrassed? Now you're embarrassed?
No, I'm not embarrassed. I'm just imagining these people being like, I'm not buying a house at home.
This state...
He can't even talk or spell good.
This state is the largest consumer of Jell-O, and it has been their official state snack food since 2001. Also, you like my little Giphy there?
I'm triggered by that criminal on the screen, Lauren. That's okay. It was out of humor.
Luckily, the word buy only has 3 letters, sell only has 4 letters, and a house has 5 letters.
I can count 6 or 3% very good.
Florida.
I'm going to go with Utah.
Guess the next best Jell-O thing.
Is kind of boring, and so I imagine is... Well, not Utah the state. Utah's probably very, very beautiful. It's got good skin.
Utah the cultural... religion side of it?
Maybe. I don't know.
Utah's the right answer.
Oh, yeah. Well, that was a just random good guess.
Yeah. Yeah. That's why I put that, because it just seemed... That's why I put Bill Cosby, because it's like Utah is like kind of like tainted. Opposite. What?
Yeah, Utah is like... They're not Bill Cosby people.
They have 6 wives that are 13 years old. Why? What's the difference?
I just imagine they were 18 and older.
Are you kidding me?
I don't know. I don't follow.
Who's the Latter-day Saints guy? What's his name? He just was arrested. Jeff Mays. Something. He was arrested because he was having wives that are, like, really young.
I don't watch the news.
They all do that.
I keep up with real estate.
Tell me what his name is,
and
y'all.
And Richmond. Because I want to know what I need to go eat.
Jeff Warren Jeffs. Oh, not Mormon.
And FLDS.
The fundamentalist Latter-day Saints.
Okay.
Okay, not Mormon, but the Latter-day Saints fundamentalists. There we go. The Latter-day Saints. He was arrested for underage wives, right? Come on, Marissa. Tell me.
Just keep moving the questions a little. We're stuck in this weird spot.
I watch shows on cults all day long. Yeah, he is super gross. And I watch a lot of these shows, and they, these people that are, like, polygamists and stuff, which that's fine. I can't even barely have one husband. I can't imagine more than one. Or if I was a husband, I can't.
Is it ever a wife with, like, 5 husbands, or it's no. always the other way around?
Would you like more than one wife? Okay, don't answer that.
Depends on who they
have
are.
A picture of him. They like have a, like a framed picture on the wall in like at least at one or every room of their house. It's weird. It's weird.
No, I feel like it'd be one wife or like 5 girlfriends, but not 5 wives.
Each Ben and Jerry's waffle cone has an average of how many little squares?
3 dashes.
I really went digging for this crap, y'all.
660, 431, 259, or 199 little squares.
Always wives because, you know, sexism. Marissa's in-laws live in Utah. She knows it. Oh, okay. Wives with multiple husbands on Twitter? Uh-uh.
A lot of people said 259. A lot of people were correct. I didn't even know where I would start to guess with that, babe.
Well, I put a picture here, like, in hopes that maybe somebody would, like...
Count?
I don't
know. But that's just a regular cone. Is that a Ben and Jerry's?
That's a waffle cone.
But a Ben and Jerry's waffle cone probably has a unique size or shape.
I tried to search Ben and Jerry's in the...
That's what came
thing,
up?
And no, nothing came up.
Well, you know you can Google search an image and then upload it.
I know, but this was all the little things were added, like...
I like that Yippie Paye... MF'er from Die Hard is number 1. I love that movie.
Wait, is Yippie Paye from Die Hard?
That's where it's most famous from. It may not be originated.
Yippie Paye? Or
no, it's Yippie Kaye.
I don't think it's from Die Hard.
Right, but
I
that's
think that
what got famous.
It. No.
Everyone knows Yippie Kaye, MF'er from Die Hard.
Obi-Wan Kenobi?
Ha!
Shut your pie hole.
Preoccupied. Pies on the prize.
I like Bon Bon Jovi. And Synonym Bun.
I swear, since we started doing themes, then the team names are my favorite part as a host.
Agreed.
By far.
Agreed. Oh,
and then when you do that one answer that was funny once about the James Brewer.
I was watching it. I had to rewatch an old one earlier. It was last week.
An old trivia?
Yeah, it was last week when I was talking about how it was mostly shark questions. And then, like, a portion of them were dog questions. And I was like, but if you just imagine that that dog question is in a shark costume, then they're all shark questions.
Did you laugh?
Yeah, at myself.
Okay.
That's why I love you. All right. Buddhist sutras state that Gautama Buddha's final meal before his enlightenment was a large bowl of what dessert? Apparently, that's, like, the Buddha. Like, what people
OG
know
Buddha.
As Buddha
OG.
Had
strawberry
this.
Shortcake, sorbet, bread pudding. That's what I'm going with. I've had all of these, and I love me some bread pudding. Shindig's bread pudding. Or D,
Ooh.
Rice pudding. That's just my answer that I want to eat. That's not my guess.
I think that
he
strawberry...
He probably ate sorbet or something lame.
Strawberry shortcake is something... It's like a dessert I forget about every year.
And then you
year.
Have it, and you're like, this is really good. Especially if the strawberries are really good.
And whipped cream. Oh, if you make your own whipped cream.
What
too?
Were they calling that whipped cream on the TV show last night? It was the Food with Phil on Netflix.
Yeah, I remember.
They were in New York City, and they were just putting...
Did you watch the Insta stories today?
Most of them, yeah.
Did you see the one where I said, am I making this too easy, and it spelled out yes and whipped cream?
Yeah.
Okay.
Rice pudding!
Good job, guys.
I'm sure I've had it, but I don't know.
You definitely had rice. I've made you rice pudding before. Clearly, it wasn't that memorable.
Better than your...
Beef stroganoff?
That's another question that we could do in Alex Lauren trivia one day.
One
meal that we had to throw away.
Yeah.
Gross.
I feel like I've only made two meals now I've had to throw away because it wasn't inedible.
The first one was infamous, though.
In my life, though? That's pretty good.
It was beef stroganoff. Remember that when we do Alex and Lauren trivia around Christmas.
We're going to do it for Christmas?
I don't know. Why not?
Okay.
It'll give everyone like a good 10 months to learn about us and forget about us. Like, not like Glazer Group trivia, like the random BS we say as we're hosting.
Yeah, like who's,
like how much, what is the drink that her brother used to burp in her face?
Who's my favorite
it's
artist?
V8, Paul Simon. Oh, I would kill at this trivia. Alright, let's keep going. What can Alex not do good? Spell. Talk.
In 1936, the first Jell-O pudding was offered. What flavor?
Was the pudding first or the Jell-O first? Probably the Jell-O.
Pudding was definitely
the pudding
first.
Was first or the Jell-O Jell-O was first?
Pudding was first.
No, they wouldn't have had Jell-O pudding if it wasn't for Jell-O.
Oh.
Right?
I feel like...
Alright, it's gotta be A or B. That's like the most basic of all dessert-y flavors.
Also, did anybody else's mom eat like a exorbitant amount of tapioca pudding growing up, or was it just me?
Your mom?
Yeah.
Your mom also would never let you eat any good cereal, like Trix or Cap'n Crunch or Lucky Charms.
Jell-O. Margaret says Jell-O, then pudding, which makes sense because of the name.
Yeah, branding.
One time Ron bought me a Sprinkle Sprangle cereal, and I'll never forget it.
She tells me about it like once a year at least. Sprinkle Sprangle, and I'm like, I don't even know what that is.
Jell-O? I used to really like Jell-O. Do you guys remember Jell-O?
I like Jell-O shots.
Jell-O jigglers, when you'd make them and like cut them out with a cookie
shapes,
cutter?
Yeah. It's my favorite part of the hour-long music.
Ooh, it's pretty tied. First flavor of pudding, what do you think?
It's probably butterscotch, because no one likes it, and they're like, let's start with that.
No, chocolate.
I would have gone, I was tied between vanilla and chocolate.
I feel like chocolate was got to be first, because, like, otherwise you're just, like, making a gel that doesn't have any flavor. Right?
Vanilla has flavor.
Well, they probably add the vanilla to give it that flavor. Otherwise, they're like, here's just a tasteless slop for you to just slide down your throat.
I want flavorless pudding.
I just saw the team name. I want to see the rest of it.
Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory was filmed where?
James River.
I think I spelled Willy wrong.
No.
That's not maybe wrong enough for a penalty. No.
Was it LA, Munich, London, or Amsterdam?
I don't know what it was. Was it Glazed Donut Shop, or was it Glazed Glazer Donuts?
Or Cake Glazers.
All right, here's another one for Glazer trivia for around Christmas. My nickname in college was Donut, and it was because one of my friends was like, your last name's Glazer, like a glazed donut. And then it just got short to Donut. I imagine that. In college, what was Alex's nickname? Donut.
I'm noticing,
dude who can't spell good.
I'm noticing WAP Bakery. Is that a play on WPA Bakery?
Probably.
Because I like that too. All right, Willie.
It was Munich
filmed
or
in
London?
Munich.
Oh.
It was because filming was cheaper there.
That's why a lot of people film in Savannah.
They had to fly in a lot of the Oompa Loompas because they did not have a lot of those in Munich. And then there was something. Yeah, Oompa Loompas. There was something about.
Is that real?
Something about a language barrier, and I just skimmed over that part, so I can't give you details. I cannot.
You can Google
details
it.
Details on that. All right, we're halfway through.
Oh, my phone heard that.
We're halfway through. So first place, we have Carol Dairy Queen.
Hi, Jack.
Second place, Cake Alicious. Third, Yippie Pie Yay.
The Risk Takers.
Fourth, V-Bird.
Curry, I'm gonna show.
Fifth, James R. I'm just gonna keep reading them until somebody stops me.
Stop! Keep going.
I like big I like big bunts and I cannot lie.
It's been there. I'm gonna press it if you don't.
Stop it.
Hold on. I'm zooming in. Hold on. All right, we got to try and end around 9:30 because people got lives.
54%
of all. You got to do the homework and stuff.
I'm trying to read the GD question, Alex. 54% of all pumpkin pie spice sales occur during this month.
It's got to be a trick question. September, October, November, December. I'm going to go with September because everyone's hype. And they're like, oh, PSL's out. Gobble it up because it just came out. Okay. And it's all through Starbucks.
Oh, wait, look. Oh, look. Oh, I put this video
on
there.
Oh, I love Gary V. He's one of my new favorite people ever.
I put that in there for you.
I appreciate it. If you don't know who Gary Vaynerchuk is, you should check him out. He's very inspirational. He'll put things in perspective and also motivate you if you're an entrepreneur or business owner.
He'll keep your husband occupied.
What, watching all his videos?
He's a large. Surprised me.
Gary Vee is a large reason why Richmond is awesome exists. So you should thank him.
Oh, excuse me. Wait, Mary doesn't like Jello shots. November. I think for like
trick
Thanksgiving
question.
And stuff. I know.
I would have thought October because of his like.
Cake-alicious took the lead. Fat fingers. All right, more than 29% of U.S. school districts have banned bake sales. But why?
Coronavirus! Unethical to target children. Food safety. No soliciting laws. Anti-obesity. I'm going with that one. So I can set this whole thing on a timer where it just goes. You'd probably hate that. Mm-hmm. Because you couldn't just ramble
sanitize
on.
Sanitize your pies. Yeah. He just wants to eliminate me from everything.
No. I would not do this without you. It wouldn't be just me sitting here.
Ooh, so it was pretty split between the two.
It's gotta be D.
It was D.
Who cares about food safety? We hate fat people. Including ourselves.
I love fat people. Including myself.
My mom hates fat people.
Yeah, does anybody else's in-laws hate fat people?
Like, just weirdly, like make all these comments
you're
all
really
the time.
Fat, and then so she just hates you too? Is it just me? Just me? Food. Oh, Nikki would have thought it was food allergies. That's
that
really
actually
smart.
Is a better answer.
Probably these days. You can't even, like. I don't know. I can't imagine. I'm lucky I don't have food allergies.
Orchids. Hummingbird cake is a
banana.
Is a banana pat.
Napple.
Pineapple spice cake common.
In the southern United States.
Where did it originate? I was trying to say it at the same time as you so we could say it like in a singing, like a chorus or harmony. Next question, let's
like,
try and...
Like Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion?
Yeah, but like we'll say the question at the same time.
I was trying to do it every other word.
And then, next time, let's try and like say it at the same time.
We've done that before.
No. I don't think we have.
JV says he's going to win. Who are you, JV?
He's Cake-alicious.
How do you know?
I'm just guessing.
That's a bold statement, Cotton. Oh,
Trashper! Oh, he's third.
Oh, V-Bird.
Trash talking.
Trashper.
I was talking and reading at the same time. Jamaica!
How'd you guys know this?
Oh, Carrytown Cupcake Hummingbird Cake? Mm-hmm. Anything from Carrytown Cupcake with the cream cheese icing is a 10
Cameron,
out of 10.
Cameron, who are you? Who's Cameron Weissenberger?
He's Cake-alicious. Z, they, she, them. Alright, let's say this question at the same time.
I know you're me.
No, like, who are you on the leaderboard? What's your trivia name? Where have you been?
Okay, how are we doing this?
You'll start saying it, and then I'll just start in, and we'll say the words at the same time. I'll try and match your cadence.
So I get to...
You just say it like normal. No. Alright, next question. Next question, we'll do it. Not this question. Next question. How much does the dessert cost?
The world's most expensive dessert is the... No. Okay. The world's most expensive dessert is the frozen hot chocolate. It contains a fine blend of 28 cocoas, including 14 of the world's most expensive. It's decorated with 5 grams of edible 23-karat gold and is served in a goblet lined with edible gold. The base of the goblet is an 18-karat gold bracelet with 1 carat of white diamonds. The dessert is eaten with a gold spoon decorated with white and chocolate-colored diamonds, which can also be taken home.
How much does this dessert cost? Why are you doing this? 5 G's. 12 stacks. 1,000
G's.
25 bricks. I don't know if these are words for thousands or not. $55,000 and 0 cents.
Ma'am, please.
So we got trash talking between 3rd and 7th. That's a healthy competition.
That is a really long question, but I had to tell you everything that came
to get
with
perspective.
This so you would know.
So you're pretty much going to say the most expensive.
Correct, one. Marissa. No aftertaste because the spoon is gold. Like, they know what they're doing. Also, I don't know about you, but everything tastes better when there's a bracelet with a carat of diamonds on my wrist. I guess. I actually never tried
jewelry's
that out
before. Jewelry's a scam. It's a bunch of shiny rocks, and they're, like, upcharging people for it.
Can you give me a salty, please? You took mine.
You drank something else instead.
No, these were all for me.
Mm-hmm.
You don't taste through your wrist, but...
Lauren's just been brainwashed to buy jewelry. That's the world we live in. We're all brainwashed to buy whatever we're buying, but... I like what I buy, so why am I going to give her crap for the crap she buys?
Yeah, my crap... just doesn't
Lauren's like,
play
why
video
do you need
games?
All these lights? And I'm like, to make the video better.
Boring. 25 grand?
Is that true? Is that accurate?
Yeah. Would you, if you had it, would you buy it?
No.
No?
No. I'd rather donate to Richmond Animal League.
Aww.
Didn't one of our winners do that last week?
Yeah. Cake-alicious, and then V-Bird. Did we ever, which one was Cameron? Ginger? Are you even on there? I wouldn't for 25 grand either. That's absurd. Okay. According to company statements, the Baby Ruth candy bar was named for the daughter of which president? Grover Cleveland, Gerald Ford, Calvin Coolidge, or Warren Harding? Okay.
You do care. You don't want either.
I would probably pick this one. Okay. Which one do you want?
Okay.
I actually don't care, unlike you, when you say that.
So apparently, this, oh.
Fun. Take a shot.
Wasn't me.
Sorry, David's mask.
Apparently, you don't want to use this blanket?
The sad part is I'm not even drunk, it's just there's a lip on the table.
Apparently, there's some, that, like, they think that they are just saying that. I don't know. I don't know.
I missed the whole question. Yeah. So I'm out of the loop.
River Cleveland. 47% of y'all knew that. All right. We're two-thirds of the way through. We have 10 questions left. We have Cakealicious in first place. Carol Dairy Queen is 9 points behind, which is not that many. And then V-Berg says they're going to win, but will they? Nikki would use her 25 grand for a trip. I get it. I would too. Oh, Ginger, I see you there. Okay. This dessert consists of small fragrant cubes of jelly, traditionally flavored with rose water, orange flower water, or lemon juice, and dusted with icing sugar, which is powdered sugar for those of you who don't know. Go ahead, Alex.
All right. La 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 la. Composotto, baklava, tulatumba, Turkish delight.
Tulumba.
I added an extra letter in there.
That's
okay. Sounded better.
Turkish delight is the right answer. I've never had Turkish delight. It doesn't look very appetizing to me, like. But I don't know. It's
composto.
It's small, fragrant cubes of jelly, ooh. Alex, dusted with icing sugar.
I'd rather have shindigs or pepper pie.
This president commonly ate Milky Way for breakfast.
What?
For like, I think for like 3 years, he ate like
Bill Clinton,
a Milky
Jimmy
Way.
Carter, Richard Nixon, Harry S. Truman.
The kid in Narnia sold his sibling for Turkish delight. Maybe it's really good. I don't know. I do like.
Or maybe
I
that's
do
just
like
all
gummy.
They have
I
the
do
time.
Like gummy things, jelly things. Might be right in my alley.
I'm gonna go with. I have no clue. You okay, babe?
Yeah, David's just real tired. Your dog is so tired, and you're like wondering if they're alive or not. Is that just me? She's alive.
She's alive.
Richard Nixon is true. And I ended up looking this up, and crook. I think there's like some
he's not a
conflicting stories, but
if
I guess
true.
Well, somebody was saying, one article said that it was during college he ate a Milky Way for breakfast every day because they were really cheap and he was really, really frugal. So, but at some point in his life he ate a Milky Way for breakfast every day.
V-Berg, he's on top!
V-Berg came
V-Berg's in. V-Berg's on top!
He said
Ginger, what are you going to do about it?
Message retracted.
What?
All right, beginning around the 9th century BCE,
the
Greeks
used...
I don't like this. This confection to heal wounds and soothe sore throats. What was it?
Why can't we try it once?
I don't like it.
Licorice, gelatin, peppermint, marshmallow.
Because it just sounds like you're trying to talk over me, which I feel like you do enough. So, for that reason, I'm out.
Alright. I'm gonna go with peppermint.
You're wrong. Excuse me. You're wrong. It's marshmallow.
You're wrong.
Little marshy marsh.
V-Berg.
I'm not a big marshmallow person.
Depends.
Too messy. Not enough like excitement. It just is, like leaves everything sticky.
True.
Okay, we got 7 questions left. You can do it. In desert terms, just kidding. Dessert terms. What is the definition of a fool?
Alex, Lauren, maybe or David.
David.
Which one of these would I want to eat? A souffle that doesn't rise properly? That could be it. I'm gonna go with that just because that made me laugh. Looks like D-Berg and Ginger are both holding their positions tightly.
Whipped cream mixed with fruit puree. I do like a souffle. Ayana.
Let's get a really cute photo.
Ayana, is this your dog? Because that is the most beautiful dog I've ever seen in my life.
That's so cute with the white and black face.
And the little speckles. And she's it's got the pink ant.
Oh my god. Is she in the chat?
Also obsessed with pit bulls, yeah. Well, I point like you can see, but yes. I need my glasses. Yes, she is. B-Berg is winning. B-Berg, no cheating now. I'm not saying you are. I'm just letting you know.
Now you can tell that they're
which
answering.
Dessert can be known as omelet surprise or Norwegian omelet, but was given its very North American and much more famous name of today. Snowball, baked Alaska, Mississippi mud pie, or Boston cream pie. What the hell are you looking at?
I'm counting, so I can see that B-Berg answered in less than 5 seconds. That'd be really hard for him to cheat.
No,
or he or she
did.
Or Z.
That's fine. I was just
now that we have the leaderboard up, you can see it jumping as people answer. It's like
all I know is I read the question and you were supposed to read the answers and
counting.
Your eyes were like.
Well, Ginger went up to 6. Making moves, Ginger. Making moves. Is it Snowball?
I already read the answers. It's Baked Alaska. I've never had a Baked Alaska.
I think I've only ever had it on a cruise, like, once.
But, you know who, Continental has a Baked Alaska.
Oh.
Never gotten it, but I should. Because I've always been
well,
really
we
curious.
Always are, as people know, too full for dessert.
I know. But also, we always go to the Continental for lunch because it's right by our office, and so, like...
Back
definitely.
When we could go to our office.
Definitely.
I never thought I would, like, miss room. Going to work. Or, like, somewhere else to work.
Yeah, like, I never thought I'd, like, miss being around people. I don't know.
Well, no, we know everyone there.
Just, like, being in public. Just, like, just people. I don't know.
Question
I don't know, man.
Whether you're actually an introvert
I don't know,
or extrovert.
Man. Whisk taker? Did I already laugh at this one yet?
Yes.
Okay. I love you guys.
I think we have...
Which dessert is made from a crunchy cookie base with a tangy or sweet cream topping?
I got you, babe. We finished each other's sentences. Coconut cream.
Hi.
Pineapple upside down. Cheese. Have you seen that TikTok where people are like trying to recreate
yes.
noises with their mouths?
I love it.
Everyone's bad at it. Everyone. No one's good.
But it's funny.
Yeah, it is.
It is cheesecake. Cheesecake's actually really easy to make, y'all.
Especially
just
if you
saying.
Have a Instapot or sous vide.
Did we make a sous vide one yet?
No, but I've heard it's easy and very good. Nick.
Pretty much anything with cream
good.
Cheese is great.
Yeah, cream cheese is life.
Mm-hmm.
Very good.
Followed by sour cream.
Or just cheese.
Because queso.
Cheese.
Cream cheese.
Queso,
sour
like Mexican
cream.
Queso.
Yeah, queso, cream cheese, sour cream.
Regular cheese.
Everything
every other cheese.
Else. Mm-hmm.
Ginger is 6. V-Berg 1. There's still time.
We have 4 questions left.
There's still time.
White chocolate cheesecake from scratch.
Set the crust.
The crust
sounds
is actually
good.
Pretty easy. You just do marshmallows.
Or is she saying
graham crackers?
Make it without the crust for the legume.
For carb.
My
mom made my brother a keto cheesecake once, and I guess the crust
was
like
edible.
The almonds.
It was edible.
Hi, watching, guy. Mom. I thought it was great.
No, it was the gluten part.
Which candy's slogan is makes mouth happy? Do you know this? I didn't know this.
Skittles, M&M's, Jelly Belly Jelly Beans, Red Vines. Look, we're a house divided. I'm a Twizzlers guy. Right, Lauren Twizzlers. Likes Red Vines better.
Twizzlers or Red Vines?
Red Vines folks. Just have like a weird texture, like they're stale when you get them. I don't get it. I don't.
I'm also a from scratch baker. I like that too. I will say that I've gotten these little the mini Twizzlers, and I like those are good. But I feel like when I get the big Twizzlers at the movie theater, it's like the flavor is like diminished. It's like 10% flavor. I like the texture of a Twizzler better, but the flavor's not there.
I like mixing bite a Twizzler and then eat popcorn and then chew it and make a mouth meal.
My dad likes to put M&M's in his popcorn.
There's definitely something about like salty and sweet that's just phenomenal.
Twizzlers are great. Ooh. Guys.
Completely random, but dessert related. Salt and vinegar may have the best pimento cheese, but also the best chocolate chip cookie we've ever had. In Churchill, salt and vinegar. Like, I thought Garth cookies were good. This is like a step up.
It's like this it's big, but it's got these big flaky salt on it.
Oh my God.
Strawberry Twizzler, says Brian. Snow caps and popcorn. Ooh, that sounds good too. Okay. The apple muffin is the official state muffin of
Vermont. I was trying to guess one of them. I had a 1-in-50 chance. Ohio, New Hampshire, New York, or Wisconsin?
Trivia Club should know this.
Oh, Ginger jumped from 6th to 5th. Vieberg holding the lead.
Also, if you're wishing you were part of Trivia Club right now, you can text us and I'll add you in next week. 804-223-2032.
How did you memorize that already?
Because 2032 is the last of my parents' home phone number, so that was just easy.
Oh, whoa.
I know.
Anyone can text us, not just winners. If you want to be in Trivia Club, text us.
If you
want free answers, like this one, that's probably, I'm going to go with New Hampshire.
Looks like 81% from New York Trivia Club or good guessers.
I'm from New York.
What do you think our state muffin is?
Cardinal.
Dogwood.
Dogwood. I'm trying to remember all of our state things, and those are only two.
That's the only two I know.
Cardinal and Dogwood.
Willy Wonka, fun fact, Dahl hated the movie. Ooh, really?
Who's Dahl?
He wrote the story.
Oh, the book?
Yeah, Charlie and Chocolate Factory.
Too bad I've seen the movie and not read the book. He should make another movie and prove whoever made the first one wrong.
Blueberry?
That's our blueberry muffin.
Oh, I was gonna say.
Is it based on like what
James we River produce? Water?
Diarrhea muffin?
Two questions.
Well, I remember those blueberry muffins you made.
This delicious dessert is made from a custard based with a very brittle, crunchy caramel topping.
Caramel or caramel?
I say caramel.
Is it caramel or caramel?
Everybody else says caramel.
Probably depends on what part of Virginia you're from.
Alex, you love this.
What? This dessert?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not really crazy about any of these.
I thought you loved one of these. Or just somebody always wants you to... Was your grandma just always wanted you to
mom.
Order one? Your
Maybe mom. My grandma or my mom always wanted creme brulee.
According to Wikipedia, we don't have one.
What?
Muffin.
Hey, no Googling!
They're off it!
I'm kidding.
Yeah, so, but I bet that Dahl would hate the Johnny Depp one even more, to be honest.
I like the original better than Johnny
I
Depp
agree,
one.
I like the original more. Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
Who is okay? Wait. Okay. The really weird lady, but I love her. She was in Fight Club.
I remember the girl in Fight Club. I have no clue what her name is or what else she's in.
It's gonna kill me. What's up? It is creme brulee, friends.
Ooh, this might be my favorite song.
What is her name? Helena Bonham Carter. She seems like a weird Johnny Depp person. What are you trying to do? We have one question left, babe. Just chill. Lies and propaganda.
Random number generator ready.
All right. One question left, my friends. Can you also put the phone number up?
So demanding.
Winners or people who want to join Trivia Club, text us.
The Dutch are the biggest eaters of candy at 65 pounds.
They've never met Lauren.
Per person a year. Americans eat about how many pounds a year?
Lauren eats 100, but that's an average though.
Is there a pen anywhere?
Three, two, one. V-Berg versus Ginger. What are the bets?
Split. Oh my gosh, look at the splits there. It's 21. We eat 21 pounds.
On average per person?
Mm-hmm. A year. That sounds about right.
Wait, does she triple what we eat in candy? They're like all Lauren's?
But no, they're probably all chocolate. They're big chocolate people, right? All right, here we go. First place, $50.
Is it V-Berg or Ginger?
You get V-Berg.
Congratulations, V-Berg.
Text us, 223-2032.
Is that Virginia Blacksburg combined?
King Delicious, you get $25 to Proper Pie. Text us. And then, random winner, $25 to Proper Pie, courtesy of Proper Pie, just because you're lucky, is...
Number 13... Lucky number 13, Carol Dairy Queen.
Carol Dairy Queen.
Well, congrats. Carol Dairy Queen plays all the time.
I know.
They deserve something. Proud of you. But...
So close, Ginger. Margaret. So close. Oh, yeah, she was married to Tim Burton. Thank you, Ayana. Thank you.
Margaret. What's the best name? This is tough.
Oh, Margaret.
If you want to comment in YouTube on your favorite name, it might help Margaret choose... I very much liked. I'm gonna scroll.
Yeah, everybody tell Margaret what your favorite names are.
Obi-Wan Kenobi was that's a good one for me.
I like that one too.
Which one did you want to give $20 to already?
The Lauren's tub of
can
tub
of candy.
Of bed candy or something.
Tub of bed candy already got $20, so let's give it to someone else. Glazer's biggest flown. Preoccupied. Hostess Malone. These are good. Holy cannoli. Alex brings home the candy paper. Oh. Only have pies for you. Sanitize your pies. Hat of the chicken. Croissant the road. Are croissants dessert, though? They are almost. They're so buttery. I'm getting hungry. Richmond is Jawsome.
A V-Berg, I gotcha.
Strawberry fat cake. Joe Pyden.
Margaret chose Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Congratulations. That is a good one.
So, that is a very good one. That is very, very good. So, Obi-Wan Kenobi, text us. Who is it? Is it?
804.
Is
223.
Is it LP?
202, 2032.
LP, is that you?
I hope
so too.
Liquid propane or lava porridge?
Oh, Obi-Wan Kenobi, we gotcha. I gotcha.
Not LP?
No, it's not LP. But it's okay. Brian.
Brian, do you want to join Trivia Club? Wait, I think you said that,
yes.
He would
like to join Trivia Club.
So I want to tell everyone right now, put it on your calendar.
I'm going to the bathroom.
October 27th. No, wait. October 29th is a Thursday. I am planning the biggest spectacular for Halloween, way bigger than 4th of July. I'm still working on figuring out the prize amounts, but it's going to be over $1,000. It's going to be epic. I'm going to give you no details, and I'm hoping it's, I don't know, I'm just building it up in my head, and I'm planning it out very meticulously. It will probably make the national news. It's going to be so just well done and awesome and amazing. Even if it doesn't, I don't care. It's going to be my crowning jewel. Probably the thing I'll put on my tombstone. Alex did blank for Halloween trivia. I am going to overhype it because it deserves to be overhyped. So that means technically it's underhyped. I'm going to hype it about as much as it needs. Mark your calendars, October 27th. There's going to be 6 or 7 rounds. I highly recommend joining us at 7:15 sharp, but 7:38 before the game starts. It's going to be like 4th of July in terms of it's going to be different rounds. You can join in late, but you may miss out on the grand prize if you don't have the most points total over all 6 or 7 rounds. I'm so excited for Halloween. I just want to start telling people about it now, but I can't tell them anything about it because it'll ruin the surprise.
Don't worry. He talks to me about it every day.
You have to be there. You have to tell everyone you know. It will be a life-changing event. It'll make you like 2020.
I also want to throw a huge shout out and thank you to our trivia player of the week, Margaret. This was fun. We appreciate you. I'm so glad that you were able to choose the theme and the prizes. And as you know, we're doing a little very, very baby different here, where we're trivia player of the week gets to pick the restaurants or the business that the prizes come from and the theme. And so I hope that you guys have enjoyed it.
And we're
open
to volunteers.
Yeah. No,
we have people that we know have been around for a while that we plan to reach out to. But if you love it, even if it's your first week, you're like, I want to be a trivia player, text us. We'll put you on the list and we'll start pre-planning. Small note, there will not be a trivia player of the week on Halloween because it's just going to be too epic and too much going on that there just won't be room for that. But every other week, which is like how many weeks until the end of the year? 50? 1,000? There'll be trivia
players of the week. At least 52 weeks until the end of the year.
At least,
right?
Man, I was thinking about Halloween for like an hour and a half today, like planning. Like, I'm so excited. It might be the greatest, I said this to me earlier, it might be the greatest achievement of my entire life.
Nikki, 2020 will never end, but it also seems like it's going so fast that I can't even, like...
It's taking forever, but it's also like, holy cow, it's mid-August.
I feel like I'm living in Groundhog's Day. Does anybody else feel that way? It's like every...
Groundhog's Day was my favorite movie until this year, and now
every
I hate the
day
movies.
Is the same,
nightmare.
But like a little bit different.
Hi, Mimi. Miko, you want to come pop out and say hi?
Let's see.
Mingo.
We got 38 people still. Let me.
What are you doing? Oh, Mad Lib? Y'all want to do a Mad Lib? Is it our new shtick?
No, I just figured we'd do it.
No, I like it.
Okay, I need...
One David. David, come back.
3 plural nouns.
3 plural nouns, please. So that's a noun, but we just add an S to it. See, I know language.
Yes. Kids.
Kids, toes, cookies.
Okay.
Houses.
I like houses. I'm gonna go with houses. I need 2 adjectives.
Did we get all the text from everybody?
I don't know. I mean, if they
should
don't
I leave
text
it
me,
up or should I switch to this?
That's good. Right? Okay. Yummy, I like that. Okay, I need a part of the body.
Or a piece of the body.
Hand, 2 people said hand at the same time.
You gotta go with hand.
Wait, I have another one. Ribs.
Mouth, toe, ribs, thumb, finger.
Okay, I need 3 nouns, a place, and an animal. Dog is an animal.
Oh, wait, I said I'd do this. This is a shot for not having any penalties. What? I don't know. I said it earlier. I'm a man of my word. Cirrus Vodka. They were a sponsor very early on.
Oh, I gotta go with Richmond for the place. You're right.
If you like vodka, I did a Tito's versus
Space
Cirrus.
Heater.
blind taste test and Cirrus won, and I
pineapple
not a big liquor drinker, but it was smoother at room temperature, which this is.
It's not a new bottle. This is the same bottle we've had for months.
I have not taken a sip of this except for a few penalty shots since like a long time ago.
Headband. All right, we're done here. All right, this is Ode to the Mutt. I think this is a dog Mad Libs. We have a lot of Mad Libs in our house. This is a perfect stocking stuffer if you have a husband that buys everything you want immediately. A little bit of this and a little bit of that. The Mutt is a bright mixed breed pup that will warm your hand and aww, chase your toes away. First of all, mutts are just like snowflakes. No two houses are alike.
That's true.
Mutts come in all shapes and kids.
Yep.
Big ones, small ones, fluffy ones, and scruffy ones.
Yep.
There's a mutt for every space heater.
That's true.
Mutts have a special way of warming their way into your ribs. There are millions of mutts in shelters that need your love and headband. They need your love more than the average pineapple, and they'll love you to the Richmond and back. So next time you're thinking about bringing home a new dog, consider a yummy mutt. That was cute. That was cute.
It wasn't funny as like as funny as you were when you said the James River was a chocolate river. Hey, that's better. I'd rather pretend it's chocolate than diarrhea. That's just,
well, it wasn't diarrhea.
It too. But when I, that's what
which
I used
you,
to.
Which do you think smells better, the rancid chocolate river or the James?
The James actually doesn't smell. Rancid chocolate would smell worse. I just went canoeing like a month ago, and it didn't smell like it.
Okay, it doesn't smell when you're like on it, but when you're like walking.
Maybe
next
in like
to
a
it.
Stagnant creek near it, yeah.
Ooh, this is a good one, but there's not that many.
The water treatment plant does smell, and especially the poop loop.
Okay, the poop loop.
Yeah.
Okay, I need.
I like the title of this one.
One, three parts of the body, one being plural. Three parts of the body, one being plural. Nose.
Knees.
Legs.
Head, shoulders, knees, and toes.
I'll do knee. I need one, two nouns, regular nouns. And then, I need another part of the body.
Nose, knees, legs are all we have so far.
Another part
cervix.
Of the body. Oh, cervix. That's a good one. A knife. Yes.
Knife. Ear.
A number. I need a number. And then
you're my number one.
Three adjectives. 13. Okay. I need three adjectives.
Who's on our website doing a website chat?
Sticky.
If you wonder if you're on our website and you started a group chat, do you guys have merch?
Promiscuous.
Yes. We actually do. Is this a trivia person on our website?
One more adjective. Oh, scary. I see scary. Okay, we're good. Oh, muscular. I missed that one. Okay, somebody, I need one, two, three, four, five plural nouns. Five plural nouns. One, two, three, five plural nouns. Bathrooms? I'm gonna go cakes because it's dessert week. Subways, I like Subways. Sprinkles, I also like sprinkles. And then c- Cassettes is good. I like cassettes.
Okay, I need one type of liquid, one verb ending in ing, and one noun.
Sorry, Demison. We have hats, beanies, frisbee, pop sockets, sunglasses, t-shirts, and hoodies.
Shirtlesses.
Oh!
Meatballs.
I forgot about that. This is too new.
Okay, hold on. Type of liquid. I got several vodkas.
Grape juice.
Okay,
vodka.
So next I have verb ending in ing and a noun. I like meatballs. Hungry. I'm gonna do meatball. What about the verb ending in ing? Squeezing. Okay. Have I got a giraffe for you? Giraffes have aroused the curiosity of bathrooms since earliest times. The giraffe is the tallest of all living subways, but scientists are unable to explain how it got its long cervix. The giraffe's tremendous height, which can reach up to 13 cassettes, comes mostly from its legs and knee. If a giraffe wants to take a drink of vodka from the ground, it has to spread its legs far apart in order to reach down and lap up the water with its huge nose. The giraffe has promiscuous ears that are sensitive to the faintest sprinkles, and it has scary senses of smell and sight when When attacked, a giraffe can put up a sticky fight by squeezing out with its hind legs and using its head like a sledge knife.
I'm trying to reenact it.
Finally, you're doing a bad job.
You can do a better job.
A giraffe can gallop at more than 30 cakes per hour when pursued and can outrun the fastest meatball. Margaret says great job.
Thank you. Right, am I embarrassing you this time?
We're down to 17 players. I have one more left.
All right, one more and then we're out. So whoever texted on our website said they're a trivia player and they want a cup, tea, or a hoodie.
Three parts of the body. Margaret thinks you should get a Grammy for that. My favorite part was when he put his feet up like this and went like that.
It said feet in the thing. I was acting.
Okay, last one. It's called My Most Embarrassing Moment is the title. I'll give you that. Arms. So I need three parts of the body. Armpits. Oh, okay. I got it. I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 nouns. Six nouns. Ooh, guitar, yard. Underwear. Leaf. Ocean. T-shirt. Okay. Three adjectives. A geographical location and a person. I'm gonna use George Washington. I'm gonna use George Washington as the person. Oh, Bermuda Triangle. Good one, Ayana. Okay, for my adjectives, I have spicy, lazy, and disposable. Okay. All right, this is it. I'm leaving after this. My Most Embarrassing Moment. By George Washington. My most embarrassing moment happened when I got on a bus to go to Bermuda Triangle. The bus was very disposable, so I stood up and held on to a leaf. At the next stop, I saw a yard get up, and I ran over to grab his t-shirt, but I accidentally jabbed my teeth into his armpits and broke his pelvis.
Oh.
And then, as I was apologizing, the bus came to a lazy stop, which caused me to drop my underwear and fall on top of a spicy lady who was carrying an ocean on her lap.
Oh!
Believe me, my guitar was red that day.
Wait, she had an ocean of WAP? That's what it sounded like. That was very promiscuous on accident.
That was very...
An ocean of red that day?
An ocean... Ocean... No, she had an ocean... She didn't have an ocean of red. She had an ocean on her lap. And then his guitar was very red that day.
Oh, guitar. What kind of perverted... I like that it just accidentally came that way.
All right, my friends. I appreciate all of you. I will see you next week. It must have been a 12 string. This has been fun, as always. If you are a winner, text us 804-223-2032. Yeah.
People want our merch. That's cute.
It is cute.
Here, I'll put up the text messages.
Thank you, Dave. We appreciate it. Thank you, Margaret. We appreciate you. And if you didn't win tonight, I hope you win next time. Invite your friends, because anytime we get 100 players, we give away $100.
If we ever hit 200 players, we're going to give out $400. And whatever happens on Halloween is going to be lit and crazy, and it's going to be a whole lot more than that.
If we can get everybody on the planet to play at the same time, then
we're going to have to upgrade our crowd per package. 2020
will end.
So, we'll just vote to change the calendar.
I think that we could do that. If you can play trivia, you can go out and vote. I feel like I sound like an old woman. Is this just what happens when you get older? Go vote, wash your hands, wear your mask.
I guess. It's like you finally realize like what's important, and then you're like, as a kid, you're like, shut up, mom. And then now you're like...
Or you realize that what's important is really not that hard, and so it really shouldn't be that big of a deal, but everybody just is...
It's terrible at
everything. I gotta go before I...
Kill on a soapbox.
Every
Who's got a soapbox?
Every Thursday, Alex is like, I wish you wouldn't have gotten so political, Lauren. And I'm like, I can't help it, Alex.
Well, I agree with everything you say, but like...
Bye, guys. Love you.
We're supposed to be neutrals as business owners, but... We love everybody. We just want everyone to be happy, but, you know, that's like a hippie, right? Is it actual? I wish. I'm a hippie at heart. Love you guys. I don't know how many are left. See you next week. Bye.